What's up, guys? Welcome to episode 18 of the Hive Mind Podcast. We're on YouTube, SoundCloud, iTunes, all of the things, so check us out wherever you want to watch us. Let's get into it. So let's do the old IRL segment. Anything interesting happen in your real life this week?
I don't know. Not really. Her brother's in town from Hawaii, so I've been playing Show 4 for a couple days, playing some Division, playing some contemplating a Crowfall upgrade, playing some. Wait, is Paragon still in an NDA?
No.
Oh, I've been playing Paragon. Thanks to you. And, yeah. That's pretty much it, man. What about you?
I've recently gotten back into Overwatch, playing that.
Really?
Because my son has access to that, of course.
Right, obviously.
And yeah, I'm on the Tracer hype right now. Like, holy fuck, is that a fun character to play?
I wouldn't know.
Yeah.
No.
Take my word for it. It's fucking great. I cannot wait. I think I might get Overwatch for the console just to fucking shit on console peasants, because I know they're gonna be garbage. Like, I just know they're gonna be garbage, and I'm just gonna go in there.
You're gonna be on a console too, and therefore,
no,
gonna be subject to. Well, have they? Because, like, with Paragon, what I noticed, one of the things I actually really like, and I guess we can talk about Paragon later if you want, but so I got the code, right, and I installed it, and I played a couple games on PC.
Uh-huh.
And then I was like, well, I wonder if I get PS4 access, too. So then I went to my living room, and I noticed that I had a free copy of the game, and I was like, that's fucking legit. So I downloaded it, and then I was sitting there on my couch, and I'm like, wait a minute, all my fucking progress is saved, too? What? Is this real life?
I didn't know. And, I actually didn't know that you got both.
Yeah. So not only do you get a free copy of the game, but all of your decks, all of your progress, all of your XP, all of everything is synchronized. And I mean, I think when I went on my console and I like played with other people, there are people on PC.
Yeah, it's crossplay. Yeah.
Yeah. So that, I mean, it's like that was a pleasant surprise, but like it's 2016. Every game should do that.
Exactly. Well, I heard the rumor earlier this week that Xbox Live and PSN are going to be coming together. Maybe, potentially.
I heard Xbox was going with PC, which they've talked about forever, but
they
were opening it. But
they can't do that. Not for like a lot of games. Like, you can do it for Paragon because it's not. Like, Paragon, I still think PC players have a distinct advantage, especially with some of those characters. You do have to aim, like the Kalari, Dagger Throw, and Sparrow, and some of those characters, while it isn't a Twitch-based FPS game, you still have to lead your targets, and it still matters.
Right.
And, like, turn speed and stuff like that. Like, just turning on a console is way harder to do than with a mouse, where you can just flick it.
Yeah, I think what they said was there had to be some, like, balancing for, like, people that are using keyboard and mouse versus people that are using controllers. But I do know that Xbox and Windows are like linked like that. And then I know Xbox said, hey, we're going to open our shit so anybody can play it on any network. But I did not hear that Sony or PlayStation was going to play ball at that and be like,
yeah, okay. Well, I think Microsoft is the one that wants to do it because the Xbox One is just shit. Like, I'll be honest, I've got one. It's just fucking AIDS.
So do I. Never play.
It's fucking AIDS, dude.
I don't get like the Rift. So I pre-ordered a Rift actually after the PSVR announcement came out.
Uh-huh.
And then I canceled my pre-order like a couple days later because I thought better about it. But like the Rift is like, oh, we're shipping with an Xbox One controller, the best controller for consoles. And like I've seen that people like think the Xbox One controller is amazing. I'll give you that the 360 controller was much better than a PS3 controller.
Yeah, I agree with that.
But I will not give you that an Xbox One controller is better than a PS4 controller, ever. Maybe the Elite one. I've never tried the Elite one.
The Elite one is nice, but it's also $150. I have a modified PS4 controller that's a scuffed PS4 controller with raised thumbsticks and paddles and all that shit. I don't know. Let me compare. I've got two controllers right here: the stock PS4 controller and the stock Xbox One.
I think I like
the stock Xbox One better than the stock PS4 because the only problem I have with the PS4 controller. Do you have one next to you, by chance?
No, I have a 360 controller.
Okay, so the thing with the PS4 controller is that both of the joysticks are close together. Like, you know how the Xbox One, there's one up top and one down low.
Right.
That's good because on a PS4, imagine you're playing an FPS game and you're trying to move right and then aim left. Your thumbs hit.
I don't think they do.
Yeah, they do if you have man hands.
Pretty sure they don't. Not with your little baby hands.
Like you're the guy off that Burger King commercial.
I guess
from like
if you have
like
a fucking palm full of dicks that are like 8 inches long, you're
I don't have that issue on the scuff modified controller because the thumbsticks are raised up. Because I got custom like 1-inch high thumbsticks because you have more control.
So you have fucking stilts. You have a
rectangle. Yeah, the controller looks fucking retarded. Like, it looks dumb as hell, but, like, actually playing with it, it feels good. Even though I haven't played a fucking peasant console game in so long. But I do think I like the stock Xbox One controller a little more.
Here's what I don't like, though. See, the 360 controller is heavy. You know,
I missed that.
And the sticks felt, like, tense, or the tension was high.
Yeah, that's the right word, yeah.
Right. So, but... The 360 or the Xbox One to me feels, number one, the thing feels like lightweight and cheap, and number two, the sticks don't feel good. Like the PS4 has
that.
I hate
how small they are, dude. I fucking hate how tiny the thumbsticks are.
Yeah, and they have that like the plastic, and there's like little knobs on them or whatever. I much prefer the PS4 like rubberized coating, I guess. I don't know. I just think
I kind of like that textured. Thing on the Xbox One controller. I just wish it was bigger, like circumference wise.
Right.
Right. Because I've got these big fucking sausage fingers that. Yeah.
Right.
I like the triggers on the Xbox One controller a lot. Like the bumpers and the triggers feel so fucking good. And the D-pad is really good. The buttons, the four buttons are good. But the tiny ass thumbsticks.
I don't like the Xbox One interface, too. Like, the actual, like, main menu UI thing.
I haven't even looked at that in so long, man. I
don't either.
I just use my Xbox One when I play Halo 5 every now and then. I haven't played that in months, so.
I bought an Xbox One and put it in, like, my exercise room, and I watch Twitch on it, and that's pretty much all I use it for. I play all the games that I play on console on PS4.
That's the best choice. If you have both the PS4, it's just better in every way.
Well, you heard they're coming out with the PS4K or the PS4.5 or whatever the fuck they're calling it.
No, I haven't. What is that?
So apparently it's like was like a little known secret, and now it's like a openly discussed secret. Like PlayStation hasn't acknowledged it yet, but all the devs are talking about it. They're doing like a hardware upgrade PS4 that. And there's not like details yet whether you can like retrofit your current one or like what the deal is, but the idea is that it integrates all the power needed for PlayStation VR, and it also will allow your PlayStation to play like 4K games with stable FPS, supposedly.
So I'll have to see it before I, dude. Most PCs can't do 4K worth of fuck.
Yeah, but...
And those are really expensive. I'll be shocked if that actually happens.
Yeah, but
happens.
I mean, there's probably some... Number one, you know...
That is a fucking cool marketing thing to call it, though. The PS4K. Like,
well, I think that's
hell.
The nickname. I think it's like the PS... Well, they don't really have an official thing yet, because Sony hasn't even confirmed it. But if you do, like, Google searches, like, all the devs are pretty much talking about, like, they've been briefed on it by Sony, and it's like...
I can see that coming out many years down the road. Like,
nah, dude,
when the PS4
so.
Is close to the end of its life cycle. Because I don't know. I feel like 4K gaming is pretty far away still.
Hold on, Broner. Let's see here. Sony PlayStation 4.5 in the making or PS4K. Rumors say that the same will be empowered with minor changes in graphical horsepower to support 4K gaming. Yeah, dude, it's, like, all over. Like, you can, like, Google it and read about it, but... Yeah, we'll see.
Well, I mean, right now, the games on the PS4 and Xbox One are barely being able to do 1080p, and
well,
a lot of the
Xbox One games
can't even do that.
They're
like 900p.
Not PlayStation 4. Has there ever been a PlayStation 4 game that got downgraded to lower than 1080? I don't think so.
Yeah, that game... Fuck, what was that game called? For whatever reason, people hated it, and I kind of liked it. The Order 1886... was not 1080p.
Really?
Yeah.
People hated on it because it was short, right?
Yeah, it wasn't 1080p, but they like masked it pretty well because it played like a widescreen movie. If that makes sense,
right?
Like it, yeah. So they got away with not having.
I think that game is like $16 at GameStop.
It's honestly, it's not that bad of a game. Like I'm kind of sad because I feel like that franchise has been killed and it had a lot of potential. Like I anyone that's played the game probably, like what I did is I got it at Redbox for a fucking dollar, and then brought it back like 8 hours later. So it was worth a dollar for sure. but yeah, I like the concept and the premise, and the characters I think were cool, and I think if they have a lot of potential for multiplayer, like if they did like a Gears of War style multiplayer with the third base cover, because it played really well, I felt like.
It looked like, you know, what's that game that shit, I really liked it, but it wasn't that popular. Hang on, let me find it on my desktop. I have it, I just didn't finish it. Oh shit! It's gonna come to me. It's not BioShock. It's Dishonored. Dishonored.
People love that game.
Do they? I didn't. Yeah, feel like it did that
game. Everyone I know likes that game. That's like one of the better games that's been out in the past few years.
I'm glad I remembered it because it's not on my desktop anymore for some reason, and I really wanted to finish it. And I heard they're making a Dishonored 2.
God,
Jesus Christ! Seriously? Are you choking? I can help.
God, why did I... Jesus.
You alright, buddy?
See, I think what happened is I did that before, and I'm trying to, like, sneak a drink in and not have it be, like, too obvious.
It was definitely obvious.
Yeah.
Failed. You failed in your mission.
Dude, I never do that. Except I haven't done... The last time I did that was when we were doing the podcast. Last time. God damn.
You're not good at drinking.
So no.
Probably be careful.
Jesus Christ.
So here, let me read this while you're fucking recovering. Sony is planning a new version of the PS4 with increased graphical power and games running at 4K per developer sources. We don't know if the current owners will be able to upgrade or if they'll buy a new device, but from what we hear, Sony started briefing developers based on conversation with the devs. This will include upgraded GPU to support both high-end 4K resolution for games and add more power to support PlayStation VR. It's unclear if it's just a name. Yeah, let's see. Current PS4 can output 4K photos and videos, but cannot support 4K for games. With this upgrade, it would. Besides resolution, developers have an opportunity to push more graphical tweaks to make the game look better thanks to more GPU. So, yeah, I mean, I think it's a beef up for the PSVR, honestly.
Yeah, I feel like I just really doubt we're going to be seeing games, like actual games, played in 4K in on the PS4 or Xbox One in any capacity. I think that's just pretty far out.
Yeah, maybe.
Because it's so much. It's like four times the resolution.
No, I got it.
And they're barely struggling to fucking do 1080p.
I built my computer about 2 years ago, and I built it... with 4K in mind, I really want that capability.
How'd that go?
I realized that it wouldn't push it because there's no GPU that can really do that outside of like SLI and or dropping your FPS way down. So it's ready for that, except that I'm waiting on someone to make a single. I don't like SLI setups. I'm waiting on somebody to make a GPU that can push 60 FPS. 4K. So right now it's good to go, but it just needs a new whatever the hell after a 980 Ti is, I guess. So we'll see. I did though, like the reason that I pre-ordered Jesus Christ, hang on, let me shut my phone off.
I've got mine cut off too.
My wife and her mom are texting pictures of like our fucking daughter in a bonnet or some shit and spamming my phone with a group message. Dude, if there's one thing in life I hate, it's group texting. And it's also the reply to all button on work emails. It makes me so angry. Because, like, I'll be sitting there and someone would be like, hey, is everybody free for a meeting on Wednesday at, like, 8 o'clock? And I'm like, oh, God, please no. Please no. And all of a sudden my inbox is like, bling, I am. Bling. Oh, this works for me. Bling. I have no problems. Bling. And I'm like, Does everybody really need to know everybody's fucking status? It makes me so angry. Anyway, that aside. What was I talking about? PSVR? Oh, yeah. So, they had the announcement, right, for PlayStation VR, and, do you see, like, are you, like, interested in this VR stuff at all?
Not at all. I think it's dumb as hell.
Really?
Yeah, really.
Why?
I just think it's stupid.
Really? Have you tried it, though?
Yeah.
What have you tried?
I tried out the Oculus a little bit, like, looking around this, like, metal room.
That doesn't sound fun.
No, I don't know. I think it's going to be one of those things that people think they want, but then when they actually have it, they'll fuck around with it for like a week or two and then never use it again.
Listen, you're a single guy in a small apartment. Do you understand the potential that VR porn has for your life?
I just don't think it's going to get... It's going to be good enough.
Could couple like VR porn with like a fleshlight and just basically just live your life at home until you get kicked out of your apartment for not paying rent.
Yeah,
I don't know. Maybe. I have a Galaxy S6.
Did you get one of those fucking cardboard things?
What? No. Oh. Jesus Christ. No. Jesus. Oh. No.
Yeah, I thought you were going that way because like you know about that, right?
The Google fucking...
The Google, like, you put your phone in, like, a cardboard box, and now it's, like, this VR device. It's like, what the fuck?
No, I did not buy a fucking cardboard box for my phone. But I bought a Gear. You know, the thing at Best Buy? I had, like, a gift card, because we bought, like, some washers and dryers, so I had, like, a big gift card for Best Buy. So I got a Gear VR pretty cheap, which is basically, like, a poor man's Oculus. So I used it with my phone, and it's fucking cool, dude. Like, I don't know. I was watching some I don't know if you call them, like, movies. They're, like, the VR, like, cinematic experiences or whatever. It was pretty cool. And so, I mean, I'm a pretty big fan of it. Like, I think it's going to catch on. Well, that's the thing is I think that what we need to see is the game support that's behind it. Because if they do, like, games right for this shit, I think it will catch on a lot. But if they don't, then it might not. But anyway, so when they launch PSVR, like, the thing is, like, the field of view is less than an Oculus. Like, the whole, like, resolution is less than Rift and Vive and everything. And this, I don't know, it just didn't... They made it, like, commercial friendly and not necessarily, like, if I'm going to spend hundreds of dollars on a thing.
Yeah, it's like, significantly cheaper, though, right?
Kinda. Rift is $600, a Vive is $800, and a PSVR is like $400, but you have to buy some things that basically make it $500. So it's not significantly cheaper. But
about all of them.
Alright, well then I won't talk to you about it too much. But I basically, long story short, I canceled it because I want to see like the reviews basically.
Yeah, that would make sense.
Drop a couple $100 on shit. And the games list doesn't look that impressive either.
I just don't think it's going to catch on because it's not like a relaxing way to play games. It's not like it's going to be awkward and clunky to have this fucking thing taped onto your head and then be running around your fucking apartment like a retard playing these VR games.
Sit in a chair, bro. You don't have to like fucking.
Yeah, but I just don't think it. I just think ultimately it's going to be something that's. It's just going to. People are just going to lose interest in it really quick. They're going to be like, okay, I can look around, whatever. Fucking, they're just going to be done with it.
Yeah, maybe. I think, if anything, the initial price points will make it slow to catch on because not every kid has, you know, $500+ to drop on one of these things.
I do think VR has a future in, like, other things, like, in, like, entertainment and, I don't know, other applications that aren't gaming. I feel like it's going to be... great in those ways, like in movie, like some sort of VR movie or something, like that would be fucking sick. But I think for games, I don't think it's really gonna catch on anytime soon.
Have you seen HoloLens?
Maybe.
It's the Microsoft version of. Hang on.
You went full fucking deep voice mode. Your mic fucked up.
Really?
God damn it. I'm assuming you never got one of those new whatevers you were supposed to get.
Hello.
There we go.
All right. I don't know why I did that. I didn't actually touch anything, so it shouldn't have. But no, I did not buy a new whatever. But this mic sounds better. That's why I used it and not the other one. But so HoloLens is not like... it's not actually VR. It's like augmented reality. So it's like you look through this glass thing and it projects holograms in your actual like space. So like you could be, I don't know, like you could go to like one of the demos they had was like trying to fix a sink, right? Like the dude the helping you would be like a plumber and that could actually like draw on like what you would actually see in the space as like an arrow for like where to tighten things and where to like do
that
shit.
That would be fucking, yeah, like that's where I think VR has a lot of legs is in like that kind of stuff. Like that'd be sick to be able to learn like how to like work on a car through VR. Like that'd be the way to, that'd be sick.
Yeah, that's what HoloLens is capable of. So like, I'm telling you, watch a video. They did a video of it with like designing a, like a sport bike, like a fucking race bike, and the bike actually looked like it was like there, and
people were that, like that. I think will take off and do well. I just don't think playing games, especially like considering how long people play games, I think it's going to be exhausting. It's going to be like just a fucking pain in the ass, and I just don't think it's going to catch on for gaming anyway. At least not for the long term.
Yeah, maybe not. Maybe
I think it's going to be more of an experience thing.
I guess. If they ever do figure out porn, though, it's going to sell out. I just want you to know that.
I don't even know. Like, it would have to be so good for me to use it for porn.
Really?
I feel like it, yeah. I never tried it, but I feel like...
You never tried porn?
No, I never tried VR porn.
Neither have I, but I can only imagine. I did, when I was... I had my phone, I did watch, like, the fucking Kim Kardashian tape on the moon, which was kind of cool. You can be, like, on the moon and, like, have a big screen... movie theater kind of thing. I think, see, it's cool for watching movies because the screen looks as big as it does in the movie theater. You know what I mean? Like, the being on the moon thing is whatever, but like, or, but I'm just saying that, I don't know. They have to make it comfortable, but I think it'll catch on. Who knows?
Yeah. Where the fuck did I, there it is. You got a topic or you want me to pick one off the list here?
I'm sure you have like a backlog of like 50.
Not as many as I'd like, but,
we can talk about, my friend who thinks that I'm an idiot because, dude, all dudes don't like dicks in their ass, if you want, from the comments from last week.
Yeah, I'm not familiar with this. Go on.
You read that discussion that I had with this guy?
No.
So first of all, a good rule of the internet is that if you ever want to have a really civil discussion with somebody, the best way to do that is to call them a fucking idiot or a moron in your first statement that you make. That always gets it off to on a good foot. But I'll read it. So referencing our discussion, right? We were talking about like dudes and pedophiles and remember all that shit we were talking about last week?
Yeah, yeah.
So this guy's comment, well, he made a couple of them, but this is the one that I responded to. Jesus, this dopa guy is a fucking head case. Dude, anal for a man is almost always going to feel good. You stimulate your prostate. It's better than penile orgasm. My gosh. He was talking about doing her in the ass. Ha ha ha. He's a moron. I'm like, okay. So I said, listen, man, if you enjoy a dick in your ass, more power to you, to each his own. Can't say I've ever tried it, but I'm 100% certain that I wouldn't find it fucking pleasant. And basically his point is that every dude enjoys shit in their ass. They just don't know about it because they have a prostate, I guess. And my point was, maybe some men do, but I assure you that not, quote unquote, all of them do. So
I've never tried it, so I wouldn't know.
Yeah, I mean... I fully acknowledge that dudes have prostates and that I'm sure some people like things in their ass, but I'm just going to go out on a limb. If you make an argument on the internet or anywhere in life and you start using the word all, every, always, like you should probably be careful about that because number one, you can never know for 100% certain. So yeah, it was a fun discussion. That was a good one from last week, by the way, though, about the pedophile thing.
I felt like people were gonna like rip me apart for that, and no one did. No one was like, "You're wrong, Zybeck." I don't know. No. Have you noticed that? Like nobody. Like I felt like that was gonna be one of those things that like didn't go over well. but like it did, and I was kind of upset. I was kind of like a little sad that there weren't people like trying to like tear me apart.
You're waiting for the quote, the pound sign triggering, and it didn't happen.
Yeah, I was kind of upset.
Okay, well,
dude, I'm not gonna lie. Like, I kind of miss the drama a little bit. Like back when, like in the old WoW days, and the SWTOR days, and the Swifty Band days, there's always some like juicy fucking drama going on, and now everybody is like cool. Like, I could actually just like piss on some like child in the middle of the street, and it could go up on YouTube, and people be like, "Yeah, let's die back."
No, you know where the drama is now is me not agreeing with all of your arguments. I get into more of the fucking drama than you do, but no, it's a good time. Yeah, I mean, I can't
think of the last time I've had like a big uprising where people were like, "Fuck Zyback," and they like spam disliked my videos. Like, it's been a while. I think it's been a few years.
What do you think we'd have to say to get that to happen? You could probably, if you shit on Bernie Sanders, you'll probably encounter it though.
We've done that for like 5 podcasts now.
Right? What could you actually say?
Have you seen the Sanders for President subreddit?
No.
Dude, it's so depressing. They're like, "Don't give up, guys. Don't give up." And the whole thing is just depressing as fuck because Bernie Sanders is like dead in the water. Like, he lost every state.
You mean like age-wise, or do you mean like both in the race for president?
Both.
Oh, okay.
Dude, his shit's over. Like, he would have to win like I think this is true. He'd have to win every single state by like 62%. And that's not gonna fucking happen.
Yeah, I mean, if he wins California though, isn't there like 500 delegates in California alone?
Yeah, but he'd have to win that and every other state by like 62%.
Yeah, I don't know. After the, I was watching the, did you see that Donald Trump basically just canceled the Republican?
I was going to talk about that. Dude, that's so gangster. Like, he made them their bitch.
He's like, "No, I'm not doing it. Fuck off." And they're like, "Well, we can't really do it now. Trump's out."
Yeah, dude, that's hilarious. He's stealing the debate without even going to it. Like, how fucking gangster is that?
Yeah. Speaking of, well, back to that topic about...
Could you imagine him, Ted Cruz, and Kasich just up there? Like, that'd be so fucking awkward. Like, he just made them their bitch. Like, how fucking great is that?
Yeah, well, I mean, to his point, he's like, "Yeah, I think we've had enough debates." And then, like...
Yeah!
What are they gonna do, like, if he just doesn't show? Kasich and Cruz are gonna debate...
Yeah, they'd look like two assholes up there.
Right? So...
Like, he becomes the elephant in the room, like, times 10,000. And it's just, like, I think he wins that debate. If he doesn't show up, he automatically wins.
He already did that.
And he won. And he would win even bigger if he did it again. Because there's less people and it's just awkward as fuck.
Yeah. I don't know, man.
I love it, dude. Funny. I fucking love it.
Well, ever since... So I was watching I think since the last podcast we had was the one where Rubio got destroyed, right? Super Tuesday on the 15th?
Yeah, he lost his own state.
So that's Rubio fucking... Well... lost. He got obliterated in Florida. So yeah, he dropped out. And then Sanders got kind of crushed in all of his things. Dude, I'm telling you, between Trump and Clinton,
dope Trump train, baby.
Dopest voting Trump, dude, I think. I'm like 85% that I'm gonna vote Trump.
Anybody but Trump Clinton. And Clinton. Anybody. I've been saying that since the start. Anybody but her. Like, even though Bernie is, like, full retard, I would so much rather have Bernie than fucking Hillary Clinton. Oh, my God. Anybody but her.
Did I tell you I did a Gary Johnson poll on Twitter?
I saw Gary Johnson sign today.
Did you really?
What? The first one.
Yeah. I'm telling you, dude. He's, like, he's famous amongst, like, super, like, anti-establishment, politically active, like, young people. I guess he's like...
Man, you must have to be politically fucking active to know who that guy is. I feel like I'm fairly politically active at this point, but I never heard of the motherfucker until you told me about him.
Yeah. Yeah. Neither has 80% of anyone, according to my Twitter.
Yeah.
But, yeah. Yeah. Speaking of, like, the shit, we're just to make a point about, you know, you're talking about the triggering and like what could you say actually.
Yeah,
our last episode, arguably the most controversial, got only 2 dislikes, and like all the other ones, that's like 80% less dislikes than the other podcasts we've ever had.
Clearly, we've resonated with our audience with the pedophile.
Apparently, your audience are pedophiles. That's what it is.
Finally, somebody who understands us.
finally, you're just resonating with your people. Oh, my God. That's
funny. I thought the last podcast was good.
Yeah. You know what I was thinking, though? Remember that you were talking about that Maldavian dude. You know what they need? You remember the Troxt soundboard?
Yes. Dude, I actually played with that guy in Classic WoW. I was on Illidan. Like a lot of those old Blood Legion guys.
I think we need more soundboards of raid leaders that are ridiculous. Like, where's the Rignaros soundboard? Or where's the fucking this guy that you're talking about soundboard? I don't know. Soundboards are... where's the Trump soundboard? I'm sure somebody's had to make a fucking Trump soundboard by now.
Soundboards were really popular back, in 2005 through 2008. There were lots of them. And now they just kind of died off. I don't know.
Okay, so do you not want to know where it is? I just Googled it. TrumpSoundboard.com.
Oh, of course.
Let's see. Insults...
I will check this out because they can hear it. How are you? Good evening. Insults.
Come on, try getting it out. So, probably I'll sue her because it would be fun.
This is awesome.
It's not that bad. I feel like it needs more, though. Like, this is actually really well done with, the video in the background and shit.
You're fired.
Anyway.
You're fired.
Anyway, did you see Arnold Schwarzenegger, too, stormed out of an interview when they asked him about Clinton because he, endorsed Kasich? Or Trump, because he endorsed Kasich. Yeah, he just stormed out of an interview.
Wait. Arnold endorsed Trump or Kasich?
Arnold endorsed Kasich and was asked about Trump in an interview in Australia and basically was like, I'm here to talk about fitness, and then fucking just deuced out of the interview. Didn't want to talk about it. So I guess... either doesn't like Trump, or he doesn't want his endorsement of Kasich to be overshadowed or something like that.
Yeah, I can't wait. When does the Republican? When does this shit come to an end? When do they actually announce the nominee?
I think once they get a majority of the delegates, then it's just done.
Yeah, how many more states are left? How much longer in this whole?
A lot. All the way into July, I think.
Fucking hell.
When do states vote?
Dude, isn't it insane how long this political process is? When did this start? Last summer, right?
So
isn't that kind of when the election started? Last summer?
Yeah, so the next one, the 19th is the Virgin Islands. The 9 delegates get awarded from the Virgin Islands.
I just can't believe how long. I mean, right, I'm not yesterday. Upset because it's hilarious and entertaining, but god damn, dude. The shit started, I think, last summer, right? Is that when it started ramping up?
Yeah, it's a long time, dude. It's a long time. So, in April, California goes April 5th. There's a bunch of people in April, May, June, August? Wait.
Wow.
No. Apparently. Oh, no, that's primary election day. Yeah, I don't know. It looks like it goes for a long time. All the way to I don't know. There's some of them are listed twice, so I don't know how accurate that is, but if you count Clinton, there's not a lot more of fucking states that need to go before they both win.
Go ahead.
Nothing good.
Oh, are you familiar with the Donald subreddit?
No, but
dude, it's like the Donald Trump subreddit, and all it is just memes and shitting on other people. And all they do, they shit on the Bernie Sanders subreddit so hard, and I think it's hilarious. So on the Bernie Sanders subreddit, they have these donation rallies where they're like, "Hey guys, I donated $7 to Bernie's campaign. Someone match me!" And it's just these insanely low donation amounts, and they get so excited for it. And people on the Donald subreddit are like, "Hey guys, I donated $0 to the Trump campaign. Someone match me." They're matched. Keep up the good. They just sarcastically shit on all the shit they do on the Bernie Sanders subreddit. I love it.
Wow. Is it reddit.com r the Donald?
R slash the underscore Donald.
Okay, because I went to the Donald, and that it looks pretty serious.
Yeah, dude, it's pretty fantastic. Like, let's look at some of the top posts here. Top
flip flop and Hillary is number two
of all time. Let's see here.
Have you seen the Hillary Clinton country music shirt?
No, I bet that's awful though.
Hang on, country music. Check this t-shirt out.
All right, Skype is taking forever to
check that shirt out.
I love Hillary Clinton.
No. I love country music is what it says.
I'm not seeing country.
Okay. What are the...
Oh, that's fucking good. I'm dumb.
See?
That's funny.
Right.
That's funny.
Yep. Let me link a better image so that
that's fucking fantastic.
Your viewership will be able to understand it.
Yeah, it took me a second there.
Yep, there we go. My buddy Haystack, who I do the Elite Nation podcast with. Well, I say I do the Elite Nation podcast. We haven't done one in like fucking a month, but he linked that shit to me. I saw it on Twitter. That's pretty good. It's pretty good.
Dude, I might buy that shirt. I'm not gonna lie. That's fucking pretty good. That's pretty funny, dude. It's funny because it's not completely obvious right away.
Right. Especially when you go, I love Hillary. What? I don't get it.
Dude, that's, I actually might buy that shit. That's fucking funny, dude. Oh, yep. God. Let's see. So, you still playing old Black Desert Online?
I haven't in... Well, I played it today before I got on because I was on my computer, but man, computer time is hard to find when you got a baby. Let me tell you. I am kind of. I mean, it's the game that I'm playing.
Revolt though against that cash shop. Like I've been following the subreddit, and like it's like one of the areas of contention constantly is the cash shop, and the ghillie suits are apparently getting out of hand, as I predicted.
Right. Let's see. All I know is that like I went to like the storage thing, you know, like where you put all your shit or whatever, and like you know how like in that game like horses and like your workers and like carts and all that shit are like persistent, like you know they stay there pretty much. Mm-hmm. So like if you go to the place where like the fucking storage is, all it is like 50 billion wagons. So yeah,
that's the top post of this week or of this month. Just this guy complaining about the ghillie suit, as I fucking predicted. Like, of course, entire guilds are going to be running the shit. It's just like so fucking broken. And what's funny is that people are buying it knowing that it's broken, like knowing that it's like an unfair, like pay to win advantage. So like the publisher is stuck in this weird situation where they either have to refund people their money.
Or I don't think they do. I don't think they do at all. I think they just nerf it.
Well, they're going to have a lot of people pissed off if they nerf it. Because
so what? There's people pissed off now.
Yeah. Yeah. They're in a shitty situation. They're in a lose-lose. That's what I was trying to say, is they're in a lose-lose situation. They either, like, the only way they can make it a win-win situation is if they refund the people that bought that shit their money back, which I doubt they will do.
They won't do. Nope. Well, look at, dude, fucking Blizzard. Like, with flying mounts. They introduce a flying mount into the game, and you can't use it in current content. Like, that was a big fucking thing for a while, and then... When they stopped allowing flying mounts to be in current content, so...
Yeah, but what was the new one they introduced?
I mean, they've introduced new ones all the time. Like, there's not one specifically.
I thought they'd have recently gone back to making ground mounts. The thing now, like I know the new Gladiator mounts are ground mounts, and
yeah, but I mean they had that Encourage looking beetle thing that they were selling. I mean,
oh yeah, I know about that. Yeah,
the armored Bloodwing too, the bat and shit like that. I don't know. I mean, that's an argument. You buy a thing and you can't even use it in the current content until, I guess now, until you do all these like bullshit achievements to unlock it. So
I wonder if Legion is going to be flyable off the start.
Oh, no. God, no, dude. No.
Not off the start. I mean, like once you get max level, or if it's going to be like Draenor, where you got to do like the whole like
Draenor thing. That's their model going forward. That makes sense, though.
I think that's fine.
Kind of. I mean, it's fine in that you have to do shit to get flying, but they're going to gate it behind patches, so obviously they're not going to allow you to do
that.
Oh,
they're gating. I didn't know that. I thought it was one of those things where once you did all the stuff, and then, oh, wow, I didn't know they were gating it behind patches. That's a little shitty.
Yep. So you'll be able to work on the achievement when Legion drops, but you won't be able to finish it. Because, I mean, like, the one in... Well, just look at the one. Well, this stuff came out in WoD, so obviously. But I mean, I'm sure there will be like rep bullshits on there that aren't like even doable until like the third or fourth drop in Legion. So I mean, you're gonna be running around the ground for a long time.
Yeah, I'm not one of those people that likes flying mounts though, so it didn't really fuck with me.
I mean, kinda. I mean, like, but they're already in WoW, so like that whole thing about. Yeah, you can skip a bunch of mobs just to fly from point to point or whatever. Like, that's to be expected in WoW now. That's not like...
Yeah, well, I do think it was one of those things that did ruin the game a little bit.
Kind of.
It just took a while for the effects to take place. Like BC, I don't know, for whatever reason, flying didn't feel like it was... Like, didn't feel like it ruined BC at all. I guess because it took so much in Burning Crusade to even get the ability to fly. It was such a gold sink. It's such a... Like, you had to be max level... And for the most part, you had to be, like, pretty deep into the expansion to be able to buy it. Because it was 5,000 gold.
Well, same deal as what they're doing now. You have to be deep into the expansion.
Yeah, but the gold sink is nowhere near the...
Like, yeah, it's not gold. It's other shit.
Yeah, but it's not even close to the same level of, like, time commitment that it was. Like, there was a chick that, like, sucked a dude's dick to get an epic flyer in BC. That's real.
What's wrong with that? What's wrong with that?
Yeah, but I'm just saying, it was such a grind and such a big deal that like there was people like selling their bodies for epic flyers back in BC.
That was the thing.
You can look that shit. Let me see if I can find it.
You know what I remember? When was the Ayliana fucking nudes thing?
I don't even know who that is.
She was the tank spot girl who had like her... She like...
Oh, here we go. Yeah. WoW player who offered sex for gold succeeds. Would do it again.
Wait, let me see.
This is the first result. I don't know if it's good. I like how this is called gaygamer.net.
Recently posted an ad.
So talk all the trash you want. I got my epic flying mount and got laid, which is more than most of you failures can hope for.
Wait, hang on.
I fucking love it.
Hang on a second. Apparently, hang on, let me read this. Hi, I'd just like to thank all the jackasses that thought it would be funny to post my picture all over the internet and make 50,000 threads about me on the WoW forums. I got my epic mount in about an hour, and that was very enjoyable for both parties, while all of you idiots probably spent hundreds of hours farming for yours or don't even have them. I won't be revealing my name or his, but suffice it to say, if I find any of you any game, I will be killing you 280% faster.
I fucking love that, dude.
Also, my new friend would like... Also, to tell all you punks to take a hike. Punks. Okay.
Well, ouch. Yeah.
I'm planning to meet him again later this week. He's getting double value for his gold. So talk all the trash you want. I got my epic flying mount, and I got laid, which is more than most of you failures can ever hope for.
Good for her. Good for her. Fuck him.
And then the top one is, you just had sex with a stranger for fake money. Think about it. Part of me is proud of her for getting laid and getting her mount rimshot, but wow.
Dude, the epic flyer at the start, especially at the start of BC, was a big fucking deal.
I like how she said
I'll be killing you 280%
faster. This chick would take a dick
faster.
For a fucking order of fucking Sonic tater tots. Look at her, dude.
Yeah, unfortunately she's not much of a looker, but
look at her, dude. She's got a face that just says
She looks like she's fucking like mid 30s. Imagine if, like,
look at those bangs, dude. Those are serious bangs. You need to. Are you gonna link this for people that? Can
yeah, yeah.
That is definitely a chick that does not take a lot to bang. But
dude, I wonder what do you think, she came out on top there, dude. An epic flyer back in the day. I would not have paid. I would not have given her $5,000. No.
Well, let me ask you. It's 2016. How much gold would you pay some chick to bang her in 2016?
I've got a lot of WoW gold.
Like, how much would you pay?
I forgot I sold. I mean, no, I didn't sell it all. I gave it to my son.
Assuming you were playing WoW seriously and you needed the gold, how much would you pay for sex in WoW gold?
So you're saying I'm selling my body for WoW gold?
No, you're some chick is allowing you to bang her. And you have to pay her WoW gold. How much WoW gold are you going to pay her?
It depends on... That varies a lot.
No. Take an average chick, like a 6.
I probably wouldn't.
Okay, like an 8.
All right. I don't know. I don't even know what a lot of WoW gold isn't anymore, dude. I'm like so detached from all that shit.
Oh, my God. Actually, this is a nude pic, so whatever.
But back then, I would say, yeah, like 5,000 gold to fuck a chick is that's a lot of gold. Like, so, she came out on top by a lot. Looking like that, she fucking came out on top. 5,000 gold is a lot of fucking gold back in BC, dude. Especially back at the start.
Yeah, so, speaking of, like, controversies. So there's this chick from Tank Spot, Aliana. I just linked her picture in the,
All right.
The thing.
Okay, yep, I can't link that to the YouTube.
Nope, you sure can't. But you can just Google alien nudes and you'll find it. But anyway, apparently she like traded her raid leader fucking like nudes for gear, basically.
As you would, yeah.
I don't
get the whole nudes thing. Like I would never like trade anything for nudes. That doesn't do anything for me. I don't know.
Wait, what do you mean? You would never give a woman anything for her nudes?
No.
Yeah, you're a lying sack of shit.
No, I'm not.
You would give nothing for nudes at all.
Not for nudes, no. Like, I'm not some sort of moral fucking crusader here. That just doesn't do anything for me.
So if Blondie Wandy was gonna just send you a picture of her fucking snatch, you for like I don't know 50 WoW gold, you wouldn't do it.
WoW gold is irrelevant. But if it was like some actual amount of something,
$5.
No, I wouldn't do it.
$5.
No, I wouldn't even do it for $5.
$1.
Why are we having this conversation? What the fuck?
Because I'm proving you wrong.
No, you would. I'm just saying I wouldn't trade anything worth anything for it. It just, I don't know. Nudes don't do anything for me.
Really?
Now, I'm not against paying for sex because I feel like everyone pays in some regard or another. It would just have to be a good deal. But even that, I don't think I don't know. It would have to be like some sort of bargain for me to be down with it. I guess I'm more frugal than I am horny.
Really?
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Do you see that there's a difference, or do you find a difference? Well, let's just use this Blondie Wandy chick as an example, because she's your thing, right?
I wouldn't say that, but...
Whatever. Just let's use her as an example.
Sure.
You'd fuck her, right? Okay, you would, obviously. So, let's say that she wants you to take her to Longhorn Steakhouse for like $100 dinner. Would you do that to be able to bang her, no consequences?
Yeah, 100, yeah.
Okay, but would you pay her $100 just straight up and just skip the dinner?
Yeah.
So there's no difference to you whatsoever?
No.
I think I agree with you.
There is a difference, but you're still paying $100 at the end of the day.
Right, exactly. I would say that most people
like, obviously,
would argue
I prefer to pay $100 to go to Longhorn Steakhouse? Because yeah. You get steak and you get laid.
Right, so you get to enjoy it too. What if you had to sit there and she was the only one that got to eat dinner for $100?
No. What kind of shit is that?
Exactly. Oh, man. Right. I would agree with you that there's virtually no difference, but I would say that society in general makes the distinction for some reason. I think prostitution.
Yeah, but the thing, but that's not really a fair thing because like it's never 100. It's not like you take some chick out for dinner and then you get laid like 100%. That doesn't happen.
Have you ever been on the internet? Like that's how you get laid.
Well, I've never done that. No.
You've never just taken a chick for dinner on the first date.
No, I've never like set some. No, I'm saying it's never 100% unless you like have some sort of like agreement. And I've never done the fucking.
You must set your sights too high, bro. It's definitely 100% from spending $100 on fucking steak.
Well, I've never. I don't do fucking high-end dates, bro. I'm all about the mini golf life.
How many McNuggets does it usually take to get your chicks naked?
That's why you buy that 20 thing. What you know how McDonald's is selling McNuggets in like bulk now? You can buy like 50 of the motherfuckers at once.
You just buy like the frozen bag of McNuggets from the freezer and just hand it to her. And you're like,
go to Walmart McNuggets and get a few bags of those Tyson. Dude, I don't even buy Tyson chicken. I buy the fucking off-brand Walmart shit.
It's not like with rib meat and like fucking saline injections. Yeah, I got it.
Yeah.
That's fine. No, I think prostitution in general should be legal and taxed, and then they should use that money for
I feel like things. Almost everybody with a brain agrees with that.
Like, yeah. And then if you're going to be a dumbass and get the HIV from like a that's your own fault, really.
Yeah, but you can get that, dude. It's a scary world out there, man. You can get that shit from anybody.
Yeah, but not, well, kind of, sort of. I mean, you gotta pick your battles, right? I mean, like, if you're going in there, like, indiscriminately just
the worst is the fucking herp. Because you can get that shit even if you're using a condom.
Right.
That's the fucking, and that shit doesn't even,
I'm gonna argue that AIDS is worse than herp, though.
Yeah. Well, yeah. But, goddamn. No, the herp is very scary because that shit doesn't even look like...
It's like one in four.
Yeah, it's like a lot of people have it, and a lot of people that don't look like they have it. Fucking hell.
Right. And the herp is not like leprosy. Like, you fucking... You know what I mean? Like, you can't really... I guess none of the STDs... Like, I don't know. Like, I feel like...
What's so scary about herpes is that there's like... You can't protect yourself from it. Like, you could fuck some chick that you think is clean, she doesn't look like she has herpes, and you got it. And she didn't even know. It's just like, what the fuck?
Right.
I just, like, threw something on accident. Whatever. I'll deal with it later.
Are you mad that you got tricked?
No, I didn't.
And, so, I mean, some, too, like, some chicks have, like, the, or some people have, like, the mouth herp. It's not even, like, the dick herp.
Most people have that.
It's a different kind. I don't have mouth herp.
You might not even know it. 90% of people have that one, dude.
Right, but I'm just saying, like, well,
I'm pretty sure I have that one because I've gotten like cold sores like that before.
See, you got the herp. That's all you need.
Yeah, but I've got the one that like 90%. I'm pretty sure almost everybody has that one, and if you don't think you have it, you probably do.
Sure, that's not true. Hang on.
No, that one is true. Yeah, like 90% of people have that one. 90%
of people have mouth herp. Enter.
Because you get that from, like, anything.
Wait. HSV-1 is what I actually have to Google, apparently. What percentage of people have HSV-1?
Yeah, and that's another one that's, like, you have it, but you don't even know.
So this article from February of 2015 says... it says a lot of words that I don't feel like reading. But it's a lot. Apparently, yeah. It says like 80% of people have been exposed, but not like actually have it.
I think that means have it. I don't know. It's so a lot of people.
Especially, okay. Studies suggest that about 80 to 90% of the people in the U.S. have been exposed to HSV-1, and about 30% have been exposed to HSV-2, which is genital.
Yeah, so that means 80 to 90% have it.
Right.
Which, yeah. I mean, makes sense, because you get that from, you get the fucking mouth herp from anything.
Right.
Yeah. So.
Yeah.
I probably have it. You probably have it. Whatever. Right. Fuck it.
At least I don't have AIDS. The only thing I don't want is AIDS. I'll take anything else but AIDS. If I had to choose, I'll take anything but AIDS. I don't want AIDS. That's bad.
Yeah, AIDS is pretty bad.
I feel like, though, that like if you're just like picking and choosing your freaking sex battles, that you probably won't get AIDS.
Cause, no. Like, the thing is the thing that people... AIDS with straight people is not really this huge epidemic that it's made out to be. It's more of a gay problem. I know people are going to think I'm homophobic for saying that, but look at the numbers. It's more of a gay male problem than anything else.
Let's see. Since the beginning of the epidemic... Well, no, that doesn't work. I don't know. These numbers are hard to find, like, on the fly, but... I would say the percentage of the population is pretty low.
Yeah, no, like, AIDS, from my understanding, is not... Like, it's, like, not that big of a deal with straight people. Like, rarely do straight people get AIDS in the United States.
If you had to cure one thing between AIDS and cancer, what would you cure?
Cancer, obviously. Cancer is such a widespread... That's a fucking dumb question. Cancer is such a widespread thing that, like, you can get cancer in, like, everywhere and everything. AIDS is, like, such a specific thing, whereas cancer is, like, such a wide... If you would have said, like, breast cancer and AIDS, then maybe I would have had, like more of a thought for AIDS.
Think about it.
Yeah, but just cancer in general, like, that's a no-brainer. Obviously cancer.
Yeah, I mean, okay, I didn't fucking, like, that wasn't, like, a question that I fucking wrote on my sheet of awesome questions to ask you. I was just on the fly. But, like, you know what I was thinking? Well, the reason that I thought this is, you know how, like, pharmaceutical companies, like there's a pretty widespread fucking thought theory that, like, they just don't cure things. They just make treatments for things. I think genital herpes is, like, one of them, right? Like, there's not really a cure for it, but there's, like, what is that?
Yeah, they have, like, medicine you take.
Valtrex? Is that what it is?
I don't know. You'd know better than I would.
right, exactly. I'm almost out, actually. I need to get out of it. What was I talking about? Oh, so, like, it doesn't really, like, right? So there's, like, this theory that, like, big pharma companies just make, like, treatments for things. They don't actually make, like, cures where they could. Mm. I don't know. Do you subscribe to that theory?
Yeah, yeah. We've talked about this on the previous podcast before, but yeah, no, I agree. I'm sure it's happened.
I just bought... you remember that guy, Martin Shkreli, the fucking skeezball that...
Yeah.
Bought that, like, was it Dapaprim, which is, like, mm-hmm. I think an AIDS drug or something. Some kind of drug. His company was Valiant Pharmaceuticals.
Mm-hmm.
He got booted out, and there's, like, a new CEO or whatever. Have you seen the stock price or chart for Valiant?
No, so, I don't. I'm not investing in any individual stocks right now.
Yeah, I got you. But just look at it. Just look at the stock chart for Valiant. So, in September
that's not Valiant. That's something else.
VRX is the symbol. September of 2015. How much do you think the stock was? It's $29 right now.
Ghoul, fucking hell! Wow. What'd you say? What was your question?
How much do you think the stock was in September of last year? $250.
And now it's 26.
29. Fuck. 29.
Oh, it went back up. Mine says 26.
52-week low is 26. Oh, wait. No, previous close was... No, yeah, it is. 26.98. Exactly. $27. Exactly. I just bought 30 shares of this.
That's probably a safe bet, dude.
A day ago, because I
down. That stock went down just because of, like, the public, like, outrage. I think that's probably a safe bet. I think you'll be alright.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I'm looking at how much money could I lose. $30 times. I bought it at $30. $30 times 30 shares, $900. Right.
Like, it's not, I don't think it's gonna get any fucking worse.
The reason that I bought it was I had ConocoPhillips. Which got slashed, and it's actually been coming back up because oil has been coming back up. But the reason I bought it was the dividend was really good. Then they fucking slashed the dividend by like 80% when the oil's not making any money. So the only thing this stock has to do is go to $60 and I've recovered all my money. And if it does anything more than that, it's in the black. So I'm like, this is a risk. It's a bet. I could lose it all. I could lose a large portion of it, but I'm looking at, this is a $250 stock about, what is September? How many months ago is that? Six months ago? Mm-hmm. $250. And, like, for years, like, it was crazy high. Like,
it'll bounce. I'm pretty sure it'll bounce back. Yeah. Like, this is just, like, bad PR. Like, whatever.
Do you hear about, when 50 Cent pumped his penny stocks?
No.
Like, you know the whole thing with penny stocks.
I know 50 Cent's actually like a smart fucking dude who made more money like with Powerade and like Coke and all that shit than he ever did rapping.
I think it's Sobe, right? Sobe or whatever is that drink.
Well, I know he had a majority stake in Powerade before they sold it to Coke, I think. Coke, right? I think they sold it to Coke or Pepsi, I don't know. But he fucking made out like a bandit.
So what you know what a pump and dump is for penny stocks, right?
Yeah.
So what he did was, here, I'll link it to you. And this was in 2011. He basically bought a bunch of shares in this company. He owned 30 million shares in this H&H Imports company or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Told all his fans to invest in the company. They did. All his shares went super up.
And then he sold them.
He dumped it and made $8.7 million.
Is pump and dump? Is that? I'm sure it's illegal, right? Is it?
Oh yeah, super illegal. Well,
people do it on the small end too, though. There's people that pump and dump that like people like me and you that go and buy up some penny stocks and they go on like random internet forums and say like, look at this, this is kind of a good value, don't you guys think? And then they'll like, you know, slowly sort of encourage people to buy it, and they'll just go around on different internet forums and, you know, pump and dump to less of an extent of what 50 Cent could do, obviously. But the 50 Cent, he's fucking smart. Like, that dude knows what the fuck is up.
I'm pretty sure it's illegal. Like, hang on.
I'm pretty sure it is too. It sounds like it is.
Is pump and dump for penny stocks illegal?
I don't think penny stocks in particular would be. I don't think you need to specify that.
No, you do. You do, because you're not going to push. You're not going to push.
You can pump and dump anything if you had enough influence.
You don't have enough influence to pump and dump an actual company. Like, you're not going to pump
and dump. They do it all the time.
You're not going to pump and dump Microsoft.
They do it all the time, though. There's been like TV stock market shows that have been accused of pump and dumping, where like the executives and
if you're a hedge fund if you're Warren Buffett and you can actually
I'm just saying it doesn't have to be a penny stock to make it illegal.
Right, but what I'm saying
I'm saying your Google search is flawed. That's all I'm saying.
Okay, well, sure. How does a pump and dump scam work? Blah 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 blah. I don't know.
I just want to know if it's illegal or not.
I'm not sure. I would assume it probably is.
Yeah,
like,
I would think so too.
If you can make a lot of money and like
and fuck over a lot of people,
seven people arrested. Oh, and
yeah.
Penny stock
here, let me show you how much better I am at this than you are. All I googled was pump and dump illegal. Answer: a pump and dump is a scam. A pump and dump scam is the illegal act. Blah 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 blah. Dude, I am so much fucking better than you at Google.
I just was telling you about how people got arrested and how they're illegal. Listen, less is more in Googling.
You're the one that typed out a fucking paragraph about penny stocks and shit. I typed in five words. You're lecturing the wrong guy here.
I removed the is, and I got pump and dump illegal, and I found an answer. So, listen.
That's exactly what I just said I put in.
Then that's not five words, you fucking cherry blow pop. That's four words.
Yeah, you're right. Quit changing the argument. This isn't about counting. Nope. This is about Google searching. I just realized it's four words, not five.
Right. So we're even. That's pretty much what I'm taking out of that, is that I can't Google and you can't count.
Yeah.
Anyway, I don't know what we're talking about with that, but that happened. Next.
I was going to look at something. I got so fucking...
Everybody...
Go ahead.
Everybody go buy VRX right now.
Your mic went retarded again.
Damn it, really?
Yep. So I actually got like super fucking lucky.
This is good?
Yeah. So I'm looking at the... So I've been investing heavily in the S&P 500, as anybody that's been watching the podcast will know. I got so fucking lucky at the start. I hit the bottom of the market when I started. Like, when I put my, like, initial investment in, I was one day away from the very absolute bottom of the S&P 500.
Right.
Yeah.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, your mic's still retarded.
God damn it. Hang on.
You just bought... How much does one of those things cost? Fuck. God damn, that shit sucks. You sound like you, like, inhaled a bunch of that, not helium, but, like, there's another gas you can inhale that makes your voice just sound deeper.
Right, what about now?
Yeah, you're good.
If it goes retarded again, I'm just going to use my fucking headset. Yeah. It's just irritating. But, I was telling everybody to go buy VRX. That's what you should do. You should go buy VRX.
Yeah, yeah, really.
Right now. Just do it. You'll be glad you did. Yeah, so, well, your index thing, that's actually what I'm invested in my Fidelity Work 401k. And, dude, lately it's been on a tear. Like, I've made a lot.
I've recovered a lot. But I'm not going to lie, I didn't make a lot just because I'm some sort of, like, genius. I got fucking lucky. Like, I didn't, like, time the market and hit the bottom. I just happened to be the fucking time I did it, and it was one day away from the bottom. Like, fucking hell. Right. I'll take it. I'll take it. It's better to be lucky than good. But I'm not going to do that anymore. Like, I'm not going to wait and see if I, like, time the market. Essentially, there's a strategy called dollar cost averaging where you essentially just buy in the second you as soon as you can, no matter what, and you make out better than if you try to, like, time it.
Right. Well, that's the thing that, I mean, I've read a lot of Jim Cramer's books and shit. He's the Mad Money guy on... yeah, I think he's on MSNBC, but his thing is basically just, you know, research fundamentals and blah, 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 and, you know, just get in when you get in. But, you know, he's more like a longer-term type guy. I would say, though, that for most people, like most people, let's be honest, most people listening to this fucking show and playing video games don't have more than, I'll say, $5,000 really to put in the market. You have that or less. You can start an account, I think, for like in Scottrade for $500 or something like that. The best.
You cut out. You know, red.
What?
Dude, your mic, man.
Hang on.
Just switch it. Fucking hell. You cut out and then you're like, hello? Hello? Yeah, dude, fuck that mic. But anyway, I'll carry this for now. I think Vanguard is a $3,000 buy-in for, like, the lowest fund. I think it's, like, $3,000 to $5,000, depending on what you want to buy. But as he was saying, there's cheaper ones if you want to do that. Any luck? Oh, my God. Professionalism at its finest.
I unplugged the wrong fucking thing. Like, I hate everything. I hate the world. Can you hear me now?
Yeah, you're a little quiet.
Yeah, well, I'm just going to use this fucking thing for now. Hang on.
You're good now. You're good. It auto-adjusted.
Okay, cool. Yeah, go on. So I'm never using that mic again, by the way, ever.
Okay.
So what were we talking about?
You were talking about how people have no money.
So I didn't say that. I said that most people listening to an internet fucking show about video games probably don't have more than, like, and it's not a knock, but, like, probably don't have more than, like, you know, $500 or $5,000 max, and that's actually, I think you can open a Scottrade account for like $400 or $500. So, most of the wisdom that I've seen from investors says that if you have a low amount of money, like I think it's even up to like $10,000, the best thing really to do is just to find a good entry point for like a index fund, for like the S&P or something like that, and then just let that kind of do its thing.
Yeah,
mutual fund type stuff. So, investment advice for people that aren't invested yet. But you should definitely save money. You should definitely save money. Don't fucking wait. Because even if you put, like, a little bit of money when you're, like, in your, like, low 20s, like, that shit gets a lot. Like,
yeah, my goal is to be, my goal is to have a net worth of $1 million by the time I'm in my mid-30s.
Really?
Yeah.
How far are you away from that?
I'm on track.
Okay. All right. How old are you?
23. Just turned 23, okay. Not that long ago.
That's pretty far. That's like what?
15 years? 10 to 15 years, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that's doable.
Yeah, I've got a bit of a head start though, so that helps.
Right. We already established
all that money that I didn't spend going to college has been compounding interest. So, yay.
Yeah, I got like a later start. Like I do save 10% of my actual pay money, which
I've been doing way more than that.
Well, it's 15 by the time I put my 401k match in it. But I mean, I have like
expenses and shit.
Yeah, see, but, I don't. I can fucking slum it.
Right.
With my cheap-ass apartment and my shitty-ass car that's all paid off for, cheap insurance.
Right.
Utilities included, fucking...
Your box
slumming
of
it.
Fucking raw dog, fucking Kellogg's protein fucking flakes. Yeah, I got it.
See, I have no problem, and, well, that, and I don't have, like... Luckily, my hobby, I make money doing my hobby. Like, my primary hobby that I would be spending a lot of money on, I make money doing it. And video games aren't that much, aren't that expensive of a hobby either, so...
Well, it's expensive when you invest $500 in Crowfall.
I've made that money back, dog.
In Crowfall?
Yeah. I made videos, and... The main reason I did that is because they didn't have an NDA. If they would have had an NDA, I'd have told them to suck a dick, but... The fact that they said they weren't going to have an NDA was like, oh yeah, I'll do this, no problem. And I made my money back.
Oh, there you go.
Or at least close. I don't know. It's hard to say if I have completely, but I will have. It'll be worth it for sure.
I contemplated it. I think I even tweeted it to you. Like, I contemplated doing the... I logged into my page, and I can get the... See, their fucking alpha testing is confusing as shit. So, like, alpha... 2 is not necessarily like the group that's testing right now. Like, it's really weird, like the way they're doing their fucking, and this is why I tweeted them these questions, because it's not fucking obvious. Like, so I'll read it to you right here. So the gold bundle says access to alpha 2 and all subsequent tests. But alpha 2 is happening right now, but it's not alpha 2.0. Alpha 2.0 is actually alpha 3.
So I think I can explain it better than they've done it. So each individual testing cycle, each individual test, like right now we just got done with the Hunger Dome, that's over. And now there's going to be this new test phase called Siege Perilous. And it starts off at pre-alpha, then it goes to alpha, then it goes to alpha 1, 2, whatever. So every single testing phase, it starts over again to where the pre-alpha people get in first, and essentially, I don't know. In my opinion, the best value is in the alpha 1 package. Like, if you want to play it early and still not spend a shitload of money, yeah, I think the alpha 1. But that's $500 bucks.
It's not even there anymore. Well, I mean, I guess it is. It's there right now. But I mean, from what I gathered from them, if you have alpha 2, you're testing right now. Like, you are playing right now.
You probably can test right now until the new thing starts. When the Siege Perilous testing starts, you'll have to wait probably a week or something, and then you'll get in. Alpha 2 should get you in to most of the testing from here on out, because they're ramping up the amount of people they're letting test.
Right, but it's not Alpha 2.0, which is Alpha 3 access. That's why this shit is fucking
confusing. I think you're fine with Alpha 2. That's all I'm saying. Anyway, if you're interested in Crowfall, use the referral link down below.
Yeah, right. Exactly. But it's 100. So anyway, back to my point. For me, it's if I wanted to test right now, it's $125 to get me from ground level backer to Alpha 2. And I gotta say, because I thought it was gonna be 99. 99 gets you to Alpha 3, but that doesn't let you test right now. I was going to do it, because I'm like, I canceled my Rift pre-order, so that was like $600 that I'm not going to have to spend in like January.
Oh, I thought you meant Rift, like the MMO. I was like, what?
No. I'm pretty sure, I think I did buy that, though, when that came out. I don't know why I did.
I did, too. I played it for like 2 days.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's about the same amount of time that I played it. I watched a couple of Crowfall videos, and I'm like, too early. It's too early.
Yeah, if you're not, it's not that big of a deal if you don't want to buy into the testing yet. It's not that great yet. I have a feeling a lot of people will buy in once the actual campaign testing starts. The Siege Perilous thing will be pretty cool, though. I think it will be pretty badass, which is the upcoming test starting in late March. So I'll probably put out some videos about that.
Right.
I'm curious if the Ranger will be playable today. They're doing a test tonight at 7, which is why I'm kind of glad we started early. Because the Ranger might be playable. That'd be sick.
I watched talking about early access stuff. Like, so Paragon, I would say that's probably, I mean, there are a couple like buggy things with it, or a couple like alpha-ish things, but not.
It's very
really.
Good.
It's not really. I mean, it's pretty much done. I mean, from what I can tell. I mean, I don't know what else they're gonna add. Like,
there is a lack of hero selection right now, but there's gonna be more for sure. Like a lot more.
Oh yeah. Well, I saw like. There's like the group that they have at like launch, and then there's like the all the blank spaces. So that's kind of cool. Let me make this point, and then we can talk about Paragon for a little bit. So like that's pretty good, right? Crow Falls early, right? But it's not terrible. I watched a video on Pantheon, which is actually like a new upcoming MMO that one of the few, I guess. It was like a pre alpha video they were showing to the community. And it fucking sucked, dude. Like, what is this, like, new trend with... I think it's a risk for companies. Like, I don't know why in like, this year or these, like, recent times, like, companies are doing this earlier and earlier shit to, like, view your game. Because, like, I gotta be honest. Like, if I played all that money and played Crowfall right now, I think my excitement level would be diminished for the game.
Yeah, I've been saying from the start with Crowfall, you're investing in the idea, you're buying into the idea, not into what the game actually is right now. Because the game right now is nothing to do with what the game is actually going to be. Like, right now they're just dropping people into a fucking box and saying, here, fight each other with our, like, laggy servers and, like, unfinished combat.
Right. Which does not sound... I mean... Why am I paying... Exactly, like, you're paying for the idea. Like, $125 well, you're paying for that?
Yeah, well, and you also get a lot of value. Assuming the game comes out and you play it, you're getting, like, a very, very good value. Like, for me, I won't have to pay for anything Paragon-related... Or not Paragon, anything Crowfall-related for fucking basically the life of the game. I've got, like, 72 months of the subscription. Like, the early Kickstarter values are insane. I've got, like, so much shit.
Right. So, just like WildStar, when shit doesn't happen, you know. Well, I hope not. But actually, right now, the $500 is 20 months of VIP membership.
Yeah, it used to... I think it's, like, 92 for the original kit. It's a lot. It's, like, eight years or something. And those VIP... The VIP tickets, essentially the subscription, is tradable with other players. So, you know, I could sell it if I wanted to. But whatever.
Right.
That's what you're buying into. You're buying into the idea, and if you buy into the idea and the game takes off and you actually play it for a while, then you are getting an incredible, incredible value, assuming the game does well. If it doesn't, then I'll look like a retard, but there we go.
Right. But I'm just saying that like it's a like a risk, right? For like
oh, yeah.
for companies because like you're showing your like I looked at that Pantheon thing. And, like, yeah, it's pre-alpha, and they're doing it for, like, people that are excited to get them, like, whatever. But the game looked like utter shit. Like, so bad that, like, I won't even look at that again forever. You know what I mean? Like,
at least with Crowfall, so they have, like, they're being smart about it. They're more telling people their idea and, like, showing them, like, their UI and concepts and stuff rather than showing them, like, tons and tons of gameplay. Like, they are letting people test, but... I feel like they're doing it in a very smart way.
I like the Crowfall UI. It looks very Elv UI-ish. You know, like the black boxes and like kind of clean little look.
I feel like Crowfall really is head and shoulders above a lot of these other Kickstarter MMO game projects, whatever you call them. I feel like they're doing theirs very, very well.
Yeah. So, I mean, but then you have shit like Overwatch where I mean, yeah, you don't buy in or whatever, but, like, let's be honest. Like, that shit is pretty much done. You know what I mean?
Overwatch has been... Yeah, I'm really curious to see how much better Overwatch is going to be at release than it is now. Because I feel like Overwatch could have actually come out, like, a long time ago.
Yeah. Yep.
Or at least could have been in some sort of, you know, buy-in, early access state. Because, like... I remember when they first started testing that game with that open beta weekend that they only ever did one of. Even though they said they were going to do a lot more.
It wasn't open beta. It was...
Oh, yeah, yeah. It was like the invite-only weekend or whatever.
Yeah,
they said they were going to do a bunch of those, and I think they only did that one.
They did one. Exactly. Like, I mean,
they did
so
one
as an update. So it's not sounding like I'm hating on Blizzard anymore. I actually did. Remember, I told you last week I discovered on the show that I got invited to Legion Beta or Alpha. So I emailed them and I was like, "Hey, this is gonna make me sound like an asshole, but I just got this email from November and I stopped using this email. So if you could update that, I still do podcasts, so I'm still an influencer. So don't take me off your list. And in fact, if you could just go ahead and add me to Alpha." That would be great. And basically they're like, you'll be on the list for the next time. So I'm like, oh, well, that was very nice of you. Thanks. So as soon as they add more people, I'll be it. But like,
yeah.
I don't know, dude. Like, after looking at Paragon, like what they've done with PS4 and PC progress, like I get that the only argument that Blizzard can have for not having, well, there's two arguments for not making Overwatch playable, like on both. Number one, there's no reason other than pure money, greed, basically, that if you buy a copy on PC, you don't get it unlocked on PS4 or vice versa.
And, I agree.
And your achievements and all that kind of shit unlocked, like saved. There's no reason for that other than Blizzard wanting money. The only reason that they wouldn't have you cross-playing is balance.
So yeah, PC players will fucking wreck. They will fucking wreck the console players.
So I can understand me being on PS4 and not being able to play with PC people and vice versa. But there's no reason that I should have to buy the game twice and have two separate, completely separate progression paths.
Yeah.
Other than, like, Blizzard.
See, because I think I want to get it. I might get it on both. Like, I actually might get Overwatch on both just because I have such a good feeling that the console players are going to be so shit. Just like, those noob assholes are going to be ripe for the fucking... Because they're going to be so bad. They're going to be so bad. Oh, it's going to be fantastic. I can't wait.
I saw a little bit of you playing... what is it? Some Overwatch. And you were on, like, what, like a 15-person kill streak or something?
Yeah, dude, I got some Tracer gameplay today. I went on a 28 kill streak with Tracer. 28.
That's retarded, dude. You see, speaking of, did you check out that game that I linked you? Speaking of Overwatch, that's, Lawbreakers. Did you actually look at that?
No.
So, just look at a little bit of this video, and you can link it to your people. But, sure. Actually, don't look at that video. That's a terrible video. Look at this PAX Prime video right here.
Is this with the wall running and shit?
It's like gravity defying. So there's like there might be wall running, but like you can like float in the air and like double jump and like it. Look
is
how
this
Overwatch-y.
Cliff Bleszinski's new game?
I don't know who that is. Who the fuck is
the guy that made Gears of War? It might be. This might be the same thing.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, I remember seeing this. Yeah, this shit looks dope as fuck. I've seen this video before.
Yeah. So. I don't know, dude. I mean, like, this won't get as much traction as Overwatch because it's not Blizzard.
Overwatch is going to do so well, not even because of the gameplay stuff. It's because it has such personality. Like, the characters are likable, and it's just, like, this colorful world that's, like, really unique and cool. Whereas this is, like, modern military whatever shooter. Like, it bleeds into everything else, whereas Overwatch is, like, this own thing where there's like a fucking gorilla in a spacesuit as a character.
No, right. Yeah, I mean, I got it. It'll do better. But, I mean, I gotta say, dude, after watching this...
This looks cool as shit.
It looks surprisingly high quality for a game I'd never heard of before. You know where I found out about this game was...
Yeah, but it could be somebody, Titanfall 2.0. You never know.
It could be what?
Titanfall 2.0.
Oh, right.
So that's what Titanfall is exactly like this, where you're like, look at the gameplay, and you're like, oh my god, this is fucking amazing. And it was, but it just kind of got old really quick.
Yeah, maybe.
Because there was like one gun.
The reason that I found out about this was the guy, that streamer, his name's Brobecue. Bro-BQ, like barbecue.
Yeah, yeah, I got the joke, yeah.
That's not a joke, that's his name.
Yeah, I get it. Go on.
Got it. Anyway, he got invited to this studio to come check out this game, and he posted about it. And then I was like, I wonder what that game is, and then I looked at it.
Yeah, it looks cool.
But Yeah, no, I agree with you. Like, Overwatch is going to do ridiculously well.
Overwatch is in this, like, stealth position, though. Like, it's not, like, super fucking hyped, though. I mean, it is, but it isn't. Because I guess because it's been playable for some people for so long that it doesn't have, like, that huge hype behind it, I don't feel like. Maybe I'm in a different circle than, like, maybe there's some people that are, like, constantly F5-ing. But do you feel like that, too? Where it's like, yeah, there's people excited for it, but it's not, like, this game that everyone's like, oh, I can't fucking wait,
Well, I mean, back to shitting on Blizzard. I was a day one pre-order of Overwatch, super hyped for it. And now that I've had to watch 90% of my Battle.net list play it every fucking day, it's like old hat. It's like I've seen videos like, yeah, Overwatch, whatever. Like, and I bought it. I mean, and I didn't cancel my pre-order or anything. And I'll, you know, I mean, I'll log in the first day and I'll play it or whatever. But like, yeah, I mean, like the hype for me is just totally gone. There's like the new, like I think it's kind of bullshit that they don't do like an early access thing where the whole community gets in.
Well, they are doing that.
No, they're not. Well, yeah, okay, 2 days.
But like 2 days, yeah. It's like 2 weeks before the game comes out. Yeah, it's a little shitty. They should have just like, done stress test weekends for the pre-order people. Like, I don't know why they only did one of those, man. That one weekend was so fun because, like, everybody, I don't know, that was such a fun fucking weekend when they did that. Well, it was like all my friends got in and it was like just cool as fuck.
The other thing that gets me is that, like, people complain about queues late night at Overwatch. You know what I mean? Like, oh, it's hard to get a whatever, or a game or whatever, because if it's like late, super late night or weekends or some shit. And there's people that like, and the other thing for me is like feedback. Like, if you day one back a game, like, you want to have some say into like how it launches with balance and shit like that.
Yeah.
But like, you don't. You know what I mean? Because, and this is just a, you know, I mean, I don't want to seem like I'm crying about it, but Blizzard does this with all their games. They did it with Hearthstone. They do it with Overwatch. They're doing it with Legion. I mean, were you the one who told me that if you killed Mythic Archimon, you're just in Legion?
Yep.
So, I mean, I guess that's okay. But
I feel like Blizzard would have gone full blown Activision with like pre-order now and get into the Legion Alpha. Like, you know.
Well, they did it with remember they did that with MOP though. They did it with the Diablo
Yeah, you had to buy a year of WoW to be able to, and you got Diablo free, right? Something like that.
Right. But there was another thing where you got into the, if you did that, I think you also got into the Mist beta, right? And their thing was, oh, we spent so much resources getting everybody into the beta. It was like a million people that we didn't really get that much testing. Shut up, fucking Blizzard.
Well, I think what happened is a lot of people just canceled they changed their credit card details, and I think they got fucked over a lot with that.
Yeah, well, obviously they don't have to give away a game, but I mean, you know, like if you, I mean, and the other thing is like, apparently if you pre-order Legion, you get early access to the Demon Hunter.
Yeah,
where the fuck? What does that mean? When is that shit out?
I think you just get to play the starting zone early.
Right. I mean, I know what it means, but what I mean is, what does that mean time wise?
You just get to play it like a week early.
No,
you just get to have your character like.
No, I got what it means. I'm just saying, like, I don't know what that means. Like, do we get it a month?
I know what it means, but I don't know what that means.
I know what. That's exactly what you just said. But I don't know the quantity of what I get, and you don't either. You said a week, but you don't know. Could it be a month?
I think it's a week.
Could it be 2 weeks?
I remember seeing a week.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, somewhere. Okay, I don't know if that's accurate or not.
Dude,
the Demon Hunter. have you played the? Oh yeah, no, you haven't.
Yes, no, I have actually.
Oh,
my son got in
for an
evening, and I've played it a little bit. Yeah.
Did you play the Demon Hunter?
Yeah, I played it for like.
Dude, how fucking crazy is that fucking class?
We talked about it a bunch.
Did you play the level 110 like pre-made character?
No, I could only play the starting zone.
Oh.
I'm gonna play, dude. It's gonna dominate my. I'm telling you, I'm gonna play it for a while. Like I'm gonna stop playing other games and play Legion when it comes out, and I'll probably main a Demon Hunter for the life of Legion.
Unless they change a lot. Like, if they keep all that mobility and all those charge mechanics, like, that's going to be so fucking fun to play. Because, like, they actually have, like, five charges. Like, five different charge mechanics on different cooldowns. It's like, going to be completely fucking bonkers if you spec your character, especially if you spec it into that, what's that? There's like a third row talent that makes your primary spinner have an 8-yard range, and you're just gonna be zigzagging around everywhere.
Right. You know what I don't. You know what got me turned off on PvP, I think, in WoW, was that. So when I first started playing WoW, I'll freely admit this, I didn't have a Naga and I didn't know what a Naga was. So I had like a normal mouse, and I had a keyboard. So I would take. I pretty much didn't even use my mouse to play. Like, I would, this is, again, this is like late Wrath. I'm brand new to MMOs. I used W, A, S, and D to move my character, and E and Q for strafe. So I keyboard turned. That was the first thing. And secondly, I actually used my same hand, 1 through 5, on the numbers above the W, A, S, D to cast.
Wait.
To cast things.
So you played in some sort of retarded, like, hand-over-hand method?
No. I did everything with my left hand. My right hand basically just clicked on things. That's pretty much it. My left hand like cast pretty much all my spells.
Yeah.
Because I used 1 through 5, and I also used Shift 1 through 5. So like that was 10 spells that I had access to, which was pretty much. I mean, I didn't use too many more. I mean, I do now, but I didn't then. That was pretty much all I used. And then I used fucking WASD, Q, and E. So. I played like that for a while. Like, I played like that, I would say, through mid-Kata.
Jesus!
Yeah.
I thought you were going to say, like, a month.
No. I played like that a long time.
Oh, my God.
You know what caused me to stop playing like that? I played a DK. I was maining a DK. And I remember we were on, it was tier 11. And, so, you know how, like, DKs were, like, the kiters, right? With Howling Blast? That was, like, the thing.
Yes, I remember. There was a time in WoW's history where Demon Hunters were, or Death Knights were the best range class in the game. Yes, very familiar.
Okay.
Wrath of the Lich King.
So, the first time I had to kite, I was still in my shitty guild, and we were on, what's the council fight that's the first fight in Throne of the Four Winds? It's not Alec here, it's the fight before that. Council of something.
Whatever.
Yeah, there's the one platform where it has plants. Do you know what I'm talking about? And it spawns all these little walking flowers, plants, ads on Heroic. Anyway, I had to kite those. So, like, how I had to kite was, like, my 2 was my Howling Blast button, right? So, like, I'm holding down, like, W, E, and A, and, like, kind of run in a circle, right? And as I'm running in a circle, like, I had to kind of, like, angle my dude kind of sort of where it faced the things because I couldn't shoot behind me because they changed that about DKs. You had to actually face what you were shooting. And so, like, I managed to do it, but I died a lot, and it was rough. And I finally got so good at it that I could finally do it, but it was rough.
Wow.
So that
happened.
Rather
than just, like jumping and flicking your mouse. And
yeah, then, hang on. We're getting to that. So I joined Static, which was a better guild, and this is right when they were forming for 25 bands, and they were doing Heroic Magma in Tier 11. And they wanted me, like, my trial was kiting the Magma adds. You know how it spawns the fucking little lavas that run around and follow you?
Yeah, it's been a while, but
you had to perpetually kite them the whole fight. Like, you never killed them. You just had somebody group them up and kite them around the room, which is fucking easy. But it was not easy when you were a keyboard turner and you had to hit the button. So I kept dying, and the raid leader, Brutal, was like, look, all you do, just jump in the air, flick around, cast, flick back around, and run. It's fucking easy. And I'm like, I cannot do that, I'm telling you. And like, so actually, what I ended up doing was I took a week. It was a while, and I was in Orgrimmar, and the only thing I was doing was running figure eights around like poles, you know, in Orgrimmar.
Oh my God.
With my mouse to train myself
doing the Rocky music?
Yeah, yeah. To train myself actually how to move with a mouse and the keyboard at the same time. And then I bought a Naga, and like my WoW life changed forever because I was like, oh my God, I've been playing like a fucking idiot for like months. So back to my original point. Before I did that, I, you know, was trying PvP or whatever, and like as I was a melee character, I would just get trained by like Melee that would just run a figure eight through me and just fucking.
Oh my god! So you were one of those people where all you had to do was just like run behind them and they would like slowly turn and you just like.
I turned faster than that, but all you had to do was run a figure eight on my character, and I was done. That's it.
Yeah.
I couldn't face you.
That's like one of the oldest of old school WoW PvP tips is to run through somebody's character and then do a 180. And if right. they keyboard turn, they just can't handle that shit.
Right, exactly. So I was that guy. Ever since then, I've just hated WoW PvP. Like, I've never really went back to it. Like, I don't try it. I don't do it. I mean, I'm not a big PvP guy anyway, but the figure eight thing was the fucking thing that did me in WoW. I think you'll find hilarious because that's probably what you did to every fucking key. You probably did it to me at one point. I didn't even know it.
Probably.
And I was on a PvP server, too, so...
wow.
Yeah, man. Life's rough.
I never... So, like, obviously, when I started playing WoW, I did all the, like, noob mistakes, and I clicked a few abilities, but I was using key bindings for the most part on a lot of my skills. I was clicking a few things here and there, but, you know, for the most part, I can always remember I always mouse-turned, and I always... keybinded all the stuff I used fairly frequently.
Yeah,
I would click
I
like some of my healing spells because I was a feral druid. I'd click.
Yeah,
some
that's
of them,
the thing. I clicked my other shit. If it wasn't one through five or shift one through five, I clicked it.
Yeah. That's well, it. I mean, there that's was good. A lot of skills in classic WoW that were like hibernate for a fucking feral druid. It's just like, yeah, I fucking clicked that.
Right. I'm telling you, man. I don't know actually what I would do if Razer stopped making Naugus. I don't know how I would play MMOs. Like, I'm so used to, like, the Naga setup. I think there's a lot of...
I never liked them. I never liked those fucking mice.
Really?
Nope. I like the G700 mouse a lot.
That's basically, like, the Logitech version of the Naga, right?
It's different, because I think it's superior, because you can hit multiple buttons at the same time. The one design problem I have with the Razer Naga is that you cannot hit multiple buttons efficiently at the same time.
Why would
because everything is on your thumb.
But why would you need to hit multiple buttons at the same time?
I hit them all the time. Any ability that doesn't have a GCD?
Any
ability that you want to use in rapid succession? Like with the G700, I can hit 1, 2, 3, 4, potentially 5 buttons at the same time comfortably and just go and hit all 5 of them if I wanted to. Or I can hit 2 at the same time. Because the buttons are laid out in different ways. I've got 4 on my thumb, and the way that the 4 are laid out on my thumb, I can hit them... I can hit them all with my thumb at the same time, or I don't know. It's laid out better. If you just look at the G700 mouse, you can see what I'm talking about. How it's easier to hit multiple buttons at the same time.
I got you. I'm just saying that, like, of all the abilities that I hit that are in between GCDs, if I'm going to hit it at the same time, it's probably macro together, and then like if it needs to be in between GCDs. I can hit the buttons fast enough that it's not an issue.
In Wildstar, it was huge for a warrior. Like I thought, like being able to hit your breaching strikes in between your globals, because that was an ability that you could use while on global that triggered a global. Like what? It was a big deal in Wildstar. And WoW, it depends on your class you're playing.
Yeah, I know. I remember that. I mean, I play. I mean, I still play my warrior in Wildstar. Speaking of, I actually heard that. Speaking of Wildstar, I think they're running on fumes, man. I think that I mean,
what gave it away? The fact that they laid off 70 plus people.
Yeah, independent anonymous source. I think they're down to like not many people left. I think the 40% report was not that accurate. So
40%. What do you mean? Wait.
Well, the one report from Polygon was like 40% of the studio got laid off.
Yeah, that's not accurate. I don't believe that for a second, dude. There's no way they had that many people still working on the game.
Yeah. So, you know what's really sad is if you go to the Wildstar forums right now, I went to them today just because I want to, like, I don't know, like, I don't want to see this game go away.
It's fucked up, but I like to go to the Wildstar subreddit and Wildstar forums just to, like, see the sadness.
So, let me read you the first couple topics of the general forum of Wildstar.
Oh, boy.
The first one was, or the second one is, introduce LFR already. There's one that says, if this was my game, what I would do. There is, what game to play next?
Wow.
Five pages of shit. And I clicked on this one because I'm like, there's got to be people that like hate on this guy. Because here's this thing, right? Here's this post. When we all heard news about Carbon's layoff, it's very disheartening. I had an amazing time playing WildStar, and I met amazing people. However, that time has passed, and it's time to move on. Even though I stopped playing this game sometime right after free-to-play, I was secretly hoping to see a comeback. It might happen, but the chances are slim. Question to the community is, what are you going to play next? I've been looking into Smite because it kind of looks like WildStar Combat, but in a MOBA game. And I'm like, this guy's going to get ate alive by this fucking thread, right? Because this is like, I mean, you don't come on a game's fucking forums and say this kind of
shit. You can on the WildStar forums.
But no, everything is like, I don't know, maybe Minecraft.
People are taking it.
I went back to shooters. Final Fantasy, please make a private server. Some game called Factorio. I'm playing The Division. I'm going back to Final Fantasy. Like, there's not one post that's like, fuck off, go away. There's not one.
Yeah, that's sad. I like to go on the WildStar subreddit just to see the sadness. It's fucked up. Like, I do the same thing with Facebook. Like, do you ever go on Facebook just to, like, look at some people that, like they're really struggling in life? And you're like, ah, this makes me feel better about my situation. Like, you know how, like, a lot of people say, like, don't go on Facebook because it makes you look depressed? Like, it makes you feel depressed because everybody only shares, like, their best things about their life on Facebook? Have you heard that premise before?
No.
Oh, well, that's something people say is, like, don't go on Facebook because, you know, you're only seeing the best of what people's lives are. And, like, there's a lot of people that go on Facebook and get sad because they're like, look at all my friends doing all this cool shit and I'm sitting here jerking off. I'm the opposite, dude. I like to go on Facebook and see all the people, like, please pray for me. Keep me in your thoughts. Need prayers. It's like, ha, motherfucker. That's right. You were a piece of shit and now you're finally getting what's coming to you.
I don't know, dude. I mean, I see that on my Facebook's kind of like, I don't... See, the problem with Facebook is that, I don't, like, I can't be me, really, because, like, everybody on there is, like, my former teachers or, like, some of my friends are on there, like, Navy contacts, but, like, a lot of them are adults or, like, coworkers, and, like, I can't post shit on Facebook that I find funny. Because, like, I'm the most outrageous of any of my circle of, like, adult friends. So, like, whereas my college roommates and shit, people I went to high school with in Navy would find it funny, like, half the people on there. Like, for example, one time, just out of shits and giggles, it's kind of stupid, but I was in relationship with some guy in my old guild.
Oh, my God. I can see how that went.
And I had one of my ex's mom wrote me on Facebook, and she's like, hey, I saw your relationship status, and I know it's none of my business, but you did date my daughter for, like, a year, and I'm just wondering, like, are you gay?
Did she gay you? Did she make you gay?
And I'm like, no, not gay. No. But so, like, that kind of shit, you know, and I've posted some other things that, like, the people that I work for at my job are, like, super conservative, like, Irish Catholic, and, like, half the shit I post is a little too red light for that. So I just don't want, like, my whole job to, like, view me negatively. But I don't know. I see what you're talking about. I definitely have people on there.
I've gotten back into Facebook recently. There was, like, a time where...
We're not even friends, bro. We're not even friends.
What's your... link me your Facebook. I'll fucking add you. See, I'm still sitting on... I'm people don't know that I'm, like... not the same person I used to be in terms of, like, looking. Like, I look so much different now. Like, anybody that hasn't seen me in a while, like, is like, what the fuck happened? Right. So I've, like, lost all this weight and gotten in shape and shit. So I'm sitting... My Facebook has remained dormant for the most part. And once I get to where I want to get to this summer, hopefully, I'm gonna let it fucking fly and blow some fucking minds.
Right. Yeah, yeah. I don't... I post shit about, like, my daughter on there, but I don't post a lot of, like...
Oh, you're one of those fucking people? The worst?
No. I don't post, like, pictures. Like, a lot of pictures. And when I do, it's, like, memed pictures of her. Or, like, ridiculous things that... So, like, oh, well, the thing that actually happened with her... you know what her favorite thing is now? So she's 4 months old. And she was sitting on there in her little crib thing, and I always, like, give her, like, raspberries, like, on her face and stomach and shit, because she's a baby and they like that.
I don't even see how to add you as a friend on here. Where's the button?
I don't know. But, like, her thing now is she goes, that's what she does. And she's 4 months old. So I thought she's pretty smart for being able to do that, because I don't think most four-month-old kids can communicate.
Oh my god, you're one of those fucking people that thinks your child is a genius.
Listen, my kid.
Oh my god, she did raspberries. What a genius!
my kid goes. I don't think your fucking kid can do that. That's all.
My kid got into the Overwatch alpha.
That's true. That's pretty impressive.
Where the fuck is the add friend thing on Facebook?
I don't know. Link me your shit.
Yeah.
Have you have you heard of, this is a random aside, but
here you go.
Have you heard of the well, obviously it's fucking that.
Yeah, I fucked up the URL. That was supposed to be my.
Is that your mom or is that like a Tinder date?
That's my mom.
Okay, just wondering. I figured it was. I added you, by the way.
Where did you find the fucking button?
It's right next to the message button.
It's not for you, dude. I swear to God, it's not for you. Do you have your Facebook, like, private or something?
Oh, yeah, I do, actually.
You fucking asshole.
You know what? I didn't want... Yeah, there's a reason that it is. But, yeah, okay. That's why I haven't got a lot of friend requests lately. Hey!
Yeah, that'll do it.
Do you remember this, who? Remember that chick that porn star that, had the gauged ears or whatever?
Yeah.
That we made fun of?
Yeah.
So, I just added you, and it was like, it had suggestions, and it, like, has me add this chick and her fucking personal Facebook right next to you, which is really weird.
Hmm.
Are you friends with a porn star, and I don't know about it?
No, but I do always... You ever go on Twitter and, like, follow a porn star, and it's just like you see all the other people that follow her that are following you, and you're like, wow, we jerk off with the same people. This is a little awkward.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. Definitely. yeah. Actually, my coworker, I think I told this story, but he used to do hot yoga with a porn star in Richmond, Rochelle Ryan, and I followed her on Twitter and had some conversations with her, but... You ever, this is kind of a random aside talking about.
I don't even know why I follow some of these porn stars. Oh, yeah, I know why, because they always tweet, like, some ridiculous, like, stupid shit.
Right, nudes that you don't put any stock in. you know what I did put on Facebook, though? Did you see what the North Korea did to this, like, dumbass American kid?
Yeah, they, like, locked him up for 15 years or some shit, didn't they?
No. That just locked him up for 15 years. 15 years of hard labor. Which is like in a coal mine, fucking eating like rotten corn to sustain yourself. Fucking like shit. Like North Korea is not like America where you get like fucking, you get to learn about Jesus and like work out and like watch TV. Like that's not what jail is in North Korea. This is like you're gonna fucking mine coal until you die.
Yeah.
Are you what's your opinion of this kid? Do you think that North Korea is being unreasonable, or do you think
obviously
this kid's
they're being
a dumbass?
Unreasonable? But yeah, he's a dumbass at the same time. Like, why do people want to go to North Korea? Why? That's the last place I'd want to go.
University of Virginia student Otto Warmbier. His fucking last name is Warmbier. So he decides it's a good idea to go to Pyongyang over the holidays. Through a China-based travel organization known as the Young Pioneer Tours. And then, apparently, he stole, like, a political propaganda poster from the hotel. And, like, got on the plane and they fucking snagged him.
Yeah, well, he's a fucking retard.
15 years. I mean, do you think we should just, like, fucking make North Korea into glass already? Or, like, what should we do with
it? We should have built a fucking water park a long time ago.
Think so?
Yeah.
Who what's this? Who's this chick you just linked?
Oh, that was the porn star I was talking about. That like I noticed that like some other people that follow like Original Hot Dog follows this same porn star. I was like, ah, wow, funny.
It says four followers you know: Reality King Zoe, which I think is another porn star, Jim Sterling, who is the guy that does.
Yeah, I that would call me off guard too. I was like, what?
Top boobs and Zyback. I'll follow this chick.
Yeah. Dude, she's pretty fantastic.
Cool. So, anyway. Yeah. The other thing that I posted not too long ago, Have you ever heard of the ESPN? Like, so you know, like, I think it was Morgan Freeman, but like, or it might have been Bill Cosby. I think it was actually Bill Cosby, but he was talking about like how some like minority families name their kids like really stupid shit.
And like, I think that was probably Bill Cosby, yeah.
And then they're like, look, if your kid's name is LaQuanda and she doesn't get a job, like, it's your fault for naming her some stupid shit that doesn't sound like she's a normal person. Like, you remember that?
Yeah, yeah. Bill Cosby was pretty infamous for, like, saying that kind of shit.
So, have you ever heard of the ESPN All-Name Team? Pretty much what they do is, for, like, college football and basketball and other things, they take people that have really stupid names, and they make, like, a team with them.
Is this like an ESPN, like, official ESPN, like, sanctioned thing that they do?
Yeah, so, like...
That sounds incredibly racist.
So, like, there's like, one.
Surely there's not a lot of white people on this.
Here you go. Ohio State, Tuff Borland, Eddie McDoom, Brodarius Ham, Boss Talaga, Pookie Maka, DiCaprio Boodle. This guy's name's DiCaprio Boodle. Like,
handsome? Wow.
Yeah.
Tariqius Tisdale?
Octavius Cooley. Yeah, these are actual people.
Tariqius Tisdale. Tariqius.
Where's that one?
Tariqius, Mississippi linebacker. Tariqius.
Some of the ones that I saw from like a couple years ago were Flamingo Monroe was a dude. Look at this guy, Texas running back, Lil Jordan Humphrey. It's actually Lil.
Dude, this one guy's got a kick-ass name, Stone Forsythe. That's actually a sick fucking name, Stone Forsythe.
Yeah, this is just one of them. So, like, if you go back and Google, like, they have them like all over the place. Dude.
This one guy's named Messiah DeWeaver.
They had a, yeah, dude. Like, can you imagine just naming your kid some like? We had like a little struggle like picking out a good name that I thought for my kid.
What'd you go with?
Her name's Keegan.
Okay.
I would never, like, it's your fucking spawn. Like, how are you going to, like, I just Googled another one. This guy's name is Quantrez Knight or Samisi Fakasiki.
One of my brother's wife was a teacher in inner city Richmond, which is like a real shithole. You know, obviously. And there was a kid named Ladasha there, and it was spelled L-A-A like that.
Yeah, no, I actually know somebody named that.
Wow.
from back home in Florida. That's not like that.
Wow, I guess that's pretty common, eh?
Yeah, yeah.
Ladasha with a fucking dash. I like Tariqius. What was that guy's name? I gotta look it up. Yeah, Tariqius.
That's a good name, bro.
You know, have you ever done that thing where you, like, think of, like, you try to, like, blackify any name? You ever done that where you, like, try to think of, like, the most ridiculous, like, shenane-wane fucking crazy name, and you're just, like, spitting them off? Like, I could have never thought of Tariqius. Like, that is, like, on a whole new fucking level.
How about this guy's name right here?
What is it?
I just linked it to you.
Oh.
He's a receiver from Winston-Salem, North Carolina.
Divine Diablo?
Diablo.
Oh, that guy plays for he plays for Virginia Tech! Can't hate on that dude.
Divine Diablo. Like, that's really your name? I don't know.
The other guy's name was Messiah.
Right. yeah, dude. Brodarius Ham. Like, why would you name your kid this shit? Like, what part of your brain is like, you know what would be funny?
You see Pookie Maka?
Yeah.
Pookie Maka?
We actually knew when I was in the Navy, we had an officer who was a girl, and her first name was Precious, and her last name was White. What do you think her middle name was?
Wait, her first name was Precious, and her last name was White?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Jesus.
Come up with Snow? The stupidest.
Snow?
Yeah, Snow. It was
Snow. Yes! Woo! Fucking nailed it.
Her name was Precious Snow White. Like, that's so fucking stupid.
Dude, I'm fucking nailed that shit. I'm so proud of myself. That's like the me predicting you seeing that guy big black cock in that other story.
Exactly.
That's one of my favorite podcast moments of all time.
Is what? Which one?
Where you were telling me like that story about how you walked in that bathroom or whatever at that job you were at, and he's like I walked in this bathroom. You were like, I walked in this bathroom and I looked over this big black guy's shoulder and guess what I saw? And I was like, I don't know, a big black cock. And you're like, actually, yes.
Right. Exactly. Oh man. Oh yeah, good shit.
Oh shit, that was awesome.
This guy's name, I've just looked up some more of these. This guy's name's Yafari or Yafarty Wurtz.
Anyway. This one guy's Sir Patrick Scott. That's not that bad.
No.
Divine. Some of these names aren't that bad at all.
How about what if your last name was McDoom? Like fucking Eddie McDoom. That's a pretty comic book name. I don't know. What is it? Traquequius? Tricarious? What was it?
Oh, I have to look at it again. Tariquius. Tariquius.
Like, that is a fucking name that will not guarantee you employment anywhere. Like, if your name is Tariquius, you're probably not going to get that good of a job.
Dude, you can tell it's a top-notch name because we can't even remember it. Right? Like, we're like, what?
It has too many
syllables. What was that again?
Right. Like, your mom bought a vowel.
Tariquius Tisdale. Fucking hell, man.
Anyway. All right. Shoot off a topic on your list.
Let me look. Come on,
phone. You hear about that? Why are you doing that? You hear about that guy that no life the division? So there's a guy that got level 30, which is max level, and level 99, which is max dark zone rank,
uh-huh,
in 1 week. And he spent 130 hours in the division in 1 week. There's only 168 hours in a week.
That sounds like what I did in WildStar.
Really? Close. Like I was gonna, maybe not I was that
hardcore.
Ask you,
maybe not that hardcore, but close.
I was gonna ask you, what is the hardest you've ever no life to game?
WildStar, hands down. Really? Yeah, that was like 16 plus hours a day for a very long time, months.
When you were raiding with Enigma, or like
both?
Okay. Wow.
What's fucked up is that I was doing that, right? And my full-time job was playing video games and making videos and stuff. So I wasn't even playing as much as a lot of those guys in Enigma were. A lot of those guys in Enigma were playing more than that.
That's crazy.
Yeah, it was insane.
Wow. I look at like some of my slash played in WoW. I have a lot. My slash played is a lot
in WoW. I don't have that much in WoW, considering how long I've been playing.
I do. Like, it's just ridiculous to me that I can look at my slash played in WoW and have it measured in years.
Mine's like, not even measured in years. I think I might have 1 year across all my characters, which is not that much considering, you know, I played it for,
yeah, I guess, 20, off and on for 10. It's a 20th of your life. Like, that's a lot, dude. That doesn't strike you as, like, ridiculous, like, when you think about it? Like, I guess no. Not.
My WildStar slash played was way more ridiculous. I had, like, 80 days played on WildStar, and I'd only played it for, like, 6 months or something.
Yeah, I know.
That was way crazier.
I'm just saying, it's kind of weird that like I have a non-zero significant percentage of my life invested in a thing that's not even real, I guess.
Yeah, but that goes for everything.
Yeah, I guess. What was I going to say? Fuck, I had a point. I don't remember what it was.
The division? No lifing?
No. It was about time or life or something. I'll come up with it. Let's go to your next thing. I'll figure it out.
Well, did you have anything else to add about the division? Like, what about that guy that
did he? No. That's just ridiculous to me for a game that like that's you know what I mean. Like, there's no reason to be that. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know.
Like, there's nothing else for that guy to do now, right?
Right, and then he's gonna cry about content. And it's another thing is like, what does that get him? You know what I mean?
Well, that's a game that has no fucking longevity. That's the problem with that game. That's why I never even bothered picking it up.
Yeah, I guess.
Because, I mean, while you say, like, oh, we played for 130 hours straight, like, 130 hours of content in an MMO is not really that much.
No. No, I'll agree. Oh, it was about just things that are stupid. And I've put this out on Twitter a couple times, but You know what the you know who got me to think about this is the guy that basically said I was a moron for my stance on not liking things in my ass.
Yeah.
He's got like a picture of like anime like on his thing. His thing is like an anime. And I said, you know what's fucking dumb? Like, do you think that hentai is like a good idea? Like people that, and there's a couple people that I follow on Twitter that like they always post like sexy picture like anime and like hentai.
Yeah, that doesn't do anything for me. But then again, neither do nudes really.
How do you beat off on something a middle-aged Japanese guy fucking doodles in a fucking art studio? Like that's just
Man, it's weird.
That's just weird as shit to me that like you could beat off on like the Flintbones, which is like cartoon characters fucking.
The Flintbones?
Yeah.
The Flintstones?
No, the Flintbones.
Oh, that's an actual thing.
Right. Star Wars, the Flintbones, World of Warcraft. Have you actually seen World of Warcraft?
No, I have not.
Oh my god, dude. You need to fix your life. It is the stupidest porn. World, let me see if I
can. I feel like porn, like, they really are fucking dropping the ball with porn. Like, I feel like I could produce something so much fucking better.
I just want to show you this picture.
And this, like, what is with the audio sync? With porn? Surely you've noticed that, right?
Just look at that photo. That chick is in World of Warcraft. I downloaded it. It's like the...
Yeah, that's just dumb.
You know what's funny? Is I actually Googled World of Warcraft and the 1, 2, 3... The fourth picture on that Google search, what do you think it is?
I have no idea.
It's the picture of the girl who paid 5,000 or got 5,000 gold.
Oh, sick.
That's funny. It's the same infamous. Picture.
Yeah, but yeah. Dude, surely you've noticed in porn with the audio desync problem, right? You've watched enough porn to have encountered that multiple times at this point, right?
I've watched porn to realize that they just don't even care about audio.
Dude, what is the fucking deal with the audio in porn? Like, it's always... I would say, like, 25% of the time, it is fucked up.
Like, this one is...
What is the deal with that? They can't I get that right.
This one is the rage of Bonin. Like, Conan, but with a B. I just don't think they care. Like,
Dude, but it's such an easy thing. Like,
you know what?
Like, I feel like...
Well, hang on. You know, like, the Kim Kardashian tape? Like, if you watch her tape, which I don't know if you probably have, most people have, but if you watch
Kardashian,
yeah, that's, they only have, like, a couple of seconds of audio, and it's looped. So it's, like, her moaning without her even moaning. Like, she's just, like, obviously not saying something, and she's like, oh, blah, you know, fucking just doing her slutty fucking, yeah, I just don't think they care.
Like, if I was gonna do porn, like, I would have, like, GoPros and fucking... Like studio quality lighting, maybe do some green screen. Like I would like
try to like companies do, dude. Not like
yeah, but it doesn't cost that much to even just like two man produce it. Like you don't need some fucking studio to do this shit. You just need to not be a fucking retard. Like all you need is a few tripods, a few cameras, and you're fucking good. That'll nail a lot of the angles.
You know what I think is funny about porn? I think it's funny that like they start to play it off like it's an actual plot, like the doorbell rings, right? And then the guy's standing there with a pizza. And then like this is like normal audio, right? There's no music or anything. And then like he comes in.
Music too.
Hang on. They come in and have a conversation where he's like, "Did somebody order a sausage?" And she's like, "I did." And then like there's and then all of a sudden it's like fucking, you know, like the fucking just music starts playing when they go after. Like that just is fucking ridiculous to me. Like, what part of them, like, deciding that they're now going to fuck cues the music? You know what I mean? Like, I just think it's hilarious.
Yeah, like, I just feel like I could do that shit so much better. Like, I'm not even talking about the fucking part. I'm talking about, like, just the production. The production, bad production value kills my boner.
You know what the
fuck? Like, it actually, like, legitimately does a little bit. Not that much, but a little bit.
You know what the funniest porn I've ever seen was? Is if you look at that film right there, have you ever seen it? It's called Pirates.
No.
So this movie came out.
You're really into this shit.
No, listen. This movie came out in 2005. And the reason I know this is because it was the most expensive porn ever made with a budget of over $1 million and features unusually high production value. So like
that's have, like, on a pretty the... official looking cover.
Yeah, it's an a actual three like, disc movie.
Set.
Yes, dude.
What the fuck? This is the collector's edition.
Yes, dude.
Fucking you hell!
You owe it to yourself to fucking check that movie out, because it's fucking it's stupid with like really really high production value.
Wow.
Yeah.
Rig Reviews called it the quote most talked about adult movie of the year.
Yeah. New York Times.
It's won a lot of awards. Best video feature, best DVD, best director, best actress, yeah. Best high quality, best high definition production. Wow.
Well, at the AVN.
AVN Awards. This thing won an Oscar.
She's not winning an actress for best Oscar by sucking a dick. Well, you do win an actress for, you do win an award for best actress by sucking a dick, but not in the same way as you do with AVN. Different. The New York Times described the film as a quote relatively high budget story of a group of ragtag sailors who go searching for a crew of evil pirates who have a plan for world domination. Also, many of the characters in the movie have sex with one another. End quote.
Huh.
Fucking the New York Times said that about the movie.
Yeah.
Yep.
I would just think like a GoPro would go a long way in porn. Like I don't know why you don't see like more of that.
Right. No, I mean I get it, right? That's supposed to be like the action camera.
I mean I've got one. Fuck. Do you ever see the airsoft videos I made?
No.
Back when I was still a fat fuck?
No.
Oh yeah, I'll link it. Let's find it here. iMac. Fuck. Day 6 maybe? Let's see here. Day 5. Yeah, here we go. Copy link address. Boom. Check this out. Dude, this is back when I was still... just watch it muted if you want to still listen, but...
Yeah, I'm just going to link you a video of pirates for your users to watch. It's a.
But look at this. These come out pretty well. Like, this is GoPro footage in a dark place, and you can see me, like, fucking kids up in airsoft. Dude, I would love to go back to this place now that I'm, like,
Wait a minute. Is this a... Is this paintball?
No, this is airsoft.
Okay,
you shoot like plastic pellets instead of paintballs.
Okay, how do you know if you get hit though?
It's like an honor system, but you can tell if there's like some guy cheating, he gets called out on it. But you can tell it's pretty obvious when some dude fucking flinches when you shoot him.
Yeah, I see you like fucking running from the barrels. This is pretty good video, actually.
Yeah, I know. The GoPro footage comes out.
The only thing
up.
I don't like about on the
dude,
GoPro
dude, look at me fucking these kids up. God damn. I so wish I could go back and just... I'm in so much better shape now. I would, like, actually murder these fools being 100 pounds lighter now.
You're not traversing the ground that fast.
Yeah, but, dude, trust me. It fucking... This shit takes your, like, energy away quick. Have you ever played paintball?
Yeah. You know the only thing I don't like about GoPros, though, is the field of view is all fucked up at the edges. You know what I mean? Like, it's not like...
You know what I'm saying? I think I could actually have adjusted that, maybe. Actually, I think I had it in the widest mode. I think that's why. I had it in, like, the panoramic mode, because I wanted it to show as much as it could.
Lol at 6 minutes 10 seconds... Where there's this fat guy just, like, hanging out behind the wood, and you just, like, come around and just shoot him in his fucking, like, side boob. And then he just turns around and gives up on his life.
Oh, I don't think I actually shot that guy. I just poked him with my gun as, like, a courtesy thing.
No, I'm pretty sure you... Hang on, let me see.
No, I think I just poked him.
Hang on. Coming around the car. No engine in it. You said bang bang and it went so I don't know.
Yeah, that's like a courtesy rule where if you like sneak up behind somebody, like you just do bang, you just like poke them and say like bang bang rather than just shooting them, because it does hurt like fucking shit if you like shoot somebody up close in the right spot.
Vagina.
Yeah, these guns, my gun shoots like 450 feet per second. It'll fucking, you know, you'll get one stuck in your skin if you're up close enough.
Yeah, I have played paintball. It's fun. I mean, I don't play it all the time, but it's fun. We play it for like, what's the little crosshairs thing? Did you add that?
Yeah, I added that so you could see when I shot people.
Oh, okay.
More easily anyway. That's like the hit marker, essentially.
Yeah, I mean, they do like, I mean, I don't know. Porn uses shit like that, but it's more like POV stuff. It's not really like with GoPros.
I just feel like I could do it so much fucking better. Some other weird
dude hanging over like another dude's shoulder with a camera. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe I'm underestimating. Maybe it's harder than it looks, but...
I mean, I think the key is getting the most amount of content on the internet for the least amount of dollars. That's like the key in porn, I think, just to make some sort of money, because, I mean, I imagine it's super...
Oh, yeah, making money is, I would think, would be very hard. Like, the money in porn is in, like, the personalities now. It's like Twitch, almost, where, like, you have to be, like, a cam whore and, like, build like a relationship with your viewers rather than just like selling your videos.
Or that you gotta have some like controversial thing about you, like Mia Khalifa being like the fucking like doing porn with like her fucking like hijab on and like playing up her whole like fucking Middle Eastern thing. But then you'll end up getting death threats like she did. Yeah.
I would just think it'd be hard to sell porn, like the actual videos. Like I know that they make a killing off of the whole like live streaming webcam thing where like people like donate money and you know buy them stuff off their Amazon wish lists and stuff like that.
Right.
That's why so many Twitch the porn stars are going to Twitch. That's where like the money is.
Yeah, I mean I imagine. I mean I just would never like there's no part of me that would like log on to Amazon and buy some
random neither would I feel I feel bad for those people that are like that do that kind of shit. Like it's almost like wow, it's like a sad thing where it's just I don't know, maybe I just don't get it. I don't know. It's the same people that go to strip clubs.
You get it.
Like I have no interest in going to strip clubs either. Like that doesn't do anything. That's like nudes for me. It doesn't do anything for me.
Yeah,
like,
I don't know, it's either,
like empty and nothing, and I feel like I'm in a really weird spot where it's just like I'm not against paying for sex, but I don't give a shit about strip clubs or nudes or any of that shit.
Well, it's because you don't get anything from it. Like, if you go to a strip club and in the VIP room, you actually get sucked off. Like, I think a lot more people would go. But I think a lot of people have your same mentality that, like, it's just they'll get a lot of money out of you for, like, nothing.
Yeah, dude, titties don't. Yeah. I'm not going to throw a bunch of money up for titties.
I mean, have you traveled a lot?
Not a lot, no.
Okay, so, I mean, like, your experience with strip clubs is limited to fucking Virginia, which is, like, not very good at all. I mean, you've probably never been to one.
How much better could, like, what's different?
Well, there's pasties, which are little things that go over your nipple.
Yeah, that, whatever. Like, that's not that, who cares?
There's a big difference between having a fucking twirly tassel on your nipple and having your, like, fucking whole tit out, though.
The other thing is
underwear on or off, like the bottom naked, like
that wouldn't do anything for me either. Like I wouldn't care if it's full nudity or not. It doesn't.
What I'm telling you is that it does change. Like, and it would do something for you if you had a naked chick.
I mean, like, it would increase the value a little bit, but not much. Like, I still doubt I would fuck around in any of those places. Right.
It doesn't make or break whether or not you go, but it definitely makes
a difference. I'm not saying it didn't make a difference. I'm just saying it makes a difference. It makes no difference for me personally.
You know what, actually the funnest time I've ever had, like doing it, you know, we talked about doing like maybe like a little random meetup at some point.
Yeah.
The most fun I ever had was when I met the Elite Nation people in Nashville. We did a meetup in Nashville for like all of us. We did a podcast together and we're like, fuck it, let's just go have a weekend or whatever. Dude. We invited like all our listeners that wanted to come show up, and there was this one crazy motherfucker that showed up, and he was like screaming shit about pussy in like the hotel lobby, and like he was already lit by the time he got there, and it was a good time, man. We had like all the fucking wings you could want in a weekend, and we went to a strip club, and I like fucking saw like it was a good time, dude. Like, because we weren't there about, like, the chicks. It was more about getting, like, wasted and, like...
Yeah, I could see that being fun.
Yeah. I mean, it was pretty cool. The sign out front said nude karaoke.
Yeah, I just know there's some dudes that go to strip clubs and, like, they have like this thing for like that one girl, and they throw like tons of money at her, and it's just like, wow, that's pretty sad.
Right. No. Yeah. No. That's yeah. But those girls count on that shit though.
And then, and there's the same thing that people do with Twitch. Like that's what people are doing on Twitch too. They've got that one girl, and they're just throwing her tons of fucking money, getting that, you know,
thinking they're getting noticed or something. Like,
yeah, thinking that like they just love that attention that that she gives them when. When he gives her money or whatever, they yeah. like fucking crave it. It's really kind of sad. Like, not that I'm like hating on what people, you know, whatever. It's your own money. Do what you want to with it. People have donated. I wonder if anybody's donated to me for that. Like, oh my god, like all these female gamers are like, I just want Zyback's attention.
Probably not.
Probably like 90% of my donations come from that. I would think, right? All my female viewers.
Definitely. Wanting to hopefully get a glance at the Zydick at some point in time.
Well, what's crazy, so I've got 4% of my audience is female, according to YouTube. And yeah, I've got 100,000 subscribers, so that means there's 4,000 bitches that are into the Zyback enough to hit subscribe.
I really don't think that's why they hit subscribe, but sure.
Dude, it's 100% for my dashing good looks.
That's why, I guess.
Yeah. What else would it be for? My gaming skill?
I don't know.
According to everyone, I'm all washed up.
Since I did this podcast, I've gotten like 55 more Twitter followers, and I think they just like the BBC, dude. That's what they want.
Yeah.
That's why they followed me on Twitter, and just hopefully that I'll post a pic of the BBC at some point. That's what yeah. But dude, the comments are fun. Like I
wish more people would leave comments.
I wish people would leave more comments.
Yeah, like, dude, that's the thing with my. I feel like there's not. I think this is kind of my own problem is that there's not that much excitement around my channel to where most people like they just watch and they don't leave comments, which is fine. You know, whatever. You don't have to leave comments, but if there was one thing I wanted more of, it would be comments. Like, I miss them. I used to get a lot more of them when, you know, my shit was more exciting.
We need to have more arguments where you say controversial shit that I don't all like agree with 100%, and then I get in fights with your viewers on the comments for the videos. That's a good time for me. That's a really good time.
I actually made a video like asking people why they didn't leave comments, because like my audience is like notoriously quiet. Even when I streamed on Twitch, like, you would think Twitch, you know, how with the way Twitch is, where there's constantly people chatting and whatever. Like, I'd have, like, 500 people watching me play Wildstar, and my chat would be dead. And people would come in and be like, ViewBots? And I'd be like, no. Just, like, no one fucking talks. And I'd be like, hit one if you're actually here and listening. And there'd be a whole bunch of ones in the chat, like, hundreds of ones. And then no one would say anything. Like, people would just watch and listen and not say anything.
The problem that I had with streaming is that I've streamed, like, in the past. I just don't like talking to no one.
Yeah, like, I'm not very good at streaming either.
I don't like talking to people that are typing. You know, it's just weird. Like, I'm like in my, you know, I guess that's what I'm doing. Well, I'm talking to you and you're talking back. But I mean, like, it's just weird to be, for me to be playing a game. Like, and just, I guess because when I watch streams, I don't like the people talk a lot. Like, I'd rather they just play the game. So, like, I think that's why I don't do it.
Yeah. For me, it's not so much I don't mind. It's not that I don't like the interacting. It's just that I don't want to be, like, constantly talking. Like, some of these streams, you watch them, and it's, like, exhausting, because they're constantly, like, and they're just, like really high-strung and whatever. Like, I like the Crip streams more than, like, that style of streamer, where it's, like, yes, they talk to the chat, but it's not, like, constant, and they, you know, it's more, like, laid back. And that's what I would do if I streamed again, but there's nothing exciting that I would want to stream. And this goes back to why my channel is like fucking there, no one leaves that many comments. It's because there's not that much excitement right now, because I'm not doing anything like super exciting yet. Crowfall, yeah. I think will change that.
Yeah, the podcast is kind of,
well, podcasts like, in general, people just listen to and don't leave comments, especially with the day it comes out on a Monday, and I feel like a lot of people just like listen to us while they're doing work or something else,
right?
But people are listening. That's good, though. Like, the average watch time is really fucking good. Like, way above average than a typical YouTube video.
Right.
Like, people are watching for, like, 45 minutes.
People like Trump's dicks and porn. That's what people like. And pedophiles, apparently. And then that one dude did post that picture that I just linked showing you that WoW China thing was an actual ripoff of WoW, because that's definitely a ripoff of Illidan. So I appreciate you, Ian Thornburg, for helping me out.
Yeah, that's pretty bad. That one is pretty bad. But that's like the only thing I saw, though.
Yeah, right. Okay. Oh, well, we won't bring
that's pretty bad, it. Though. Yeah, that's like, it's got the hooves, the sweatpants, the tattoos, the horns, glaives. The wings.
The glaives.
Yeah, well, it doesn't have glaives, those are just like swords, but are those glaives? I can't see. Is it double-sided on the other? I can't tell.
Maybe. It's got the Lich King belt on, which is like
kind of weird. Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is pretty bad.
Anyway.
What kind of fucking theme park is that, though? Like, honestly, what the hell?
I don't know.
That's weird. It's pretty dark for a theme park. Typically, theme parks are a little more uplifting than some demonic fucking glaive-wielding freak with horse hooves.
Hey, man, it's China. They have weird shit in China.
They build a whole bunch of, like, hotels and shit that no one stays in.
I do like this one comment, though, about us doing a Q&A segment. We should definitely do that. We should be like, because we talk about people making dumb or, you know, interesting comments, but we should definitely have a segment when people just ask questions.
Yeah, just leave your questions down below in the comments and we'll answer them in the next podcast.
Would you fuck retarded Kate Upton?
Sure, anything.
Right.
By the way, I read all of the comments because YouTube's got this new comment system. It's not new, it's been out for a while, but I actually read all of the comments, literally, that come into any of my videos now. So, if you leave a comment, I promise I read it, and I respond to most of them. So, leave a comment for the Q&A section next week, I guess.
Right. And, I respond to a lot of them, too. Especially if you started off with calling me, like, idiot or a moron or a jackass or a head case, I will love that. And you should do more of that, and then I will get in an argument with you, and it'll be a good time.
Yeah.
This one chick called me Atheism Prod, it's like a zombie.
Yeah, that person's actually been watching my videos a long time. I know really? That name.
Is that a chick or is that a dude?
I don't know. I think it's a chick. I don't know.
Because if that's a chick, I mean, good for you. Because that's a nice, not like the mouth part of it, but you hit the lottery in the cleavage department.
I think anyway, it's a chick. I don't know. You can't fucking tell.
Hopefully those are really your boobs. And if they are, thank you for posting the picture of them. But she, he or she or whatever said, what were we talking about? First of all, she said, black people won't let racism go. It's all they have. To which I responded, I demand reparations for that comment. And then she also said, gorillas give oral, which I think was in talking about, like, do animals, like, do things that aren't just, like, banging. And then I said, that's not a nice name to call black folk. So, anyway, yes.
Okay. Let's see here.
Monkeys also fling their own shit.
I've got a nice story here. Man dies of hypothermia after binge eating 60 gallons of ice cream.
I don't feel like that's real.
It is. Family wants to sue the ice cream company because there was no legal notice of eating of the dangers of eating ice cream.
Like that. That's not real. Like it.
I think it's real.
First of all, 60 gallons.
I looked it up on multiple.
That's a lot of fucking Tic Tac for. You're like clickety clickety click. Just link your fucking thing you're reading.
Oh, I wrote it off my iPhone on my notes. Oh.
WorldNewsDailyReport.com.
It's on multiple news websites. I don't know if it's real or not.
The young man suffered from an extreme case of binge eating disorder, had an estimated 60 gallons of ice cream before succumbing to a heart failure caused by a lethal drop of his body core temperature.
That's pretty intense. It's a lot of fucking ice cream.
60 gallons? There's no way.
That's a lot. But that doesn't say how long of a time period he was eating it.
I guess if you're, like, eating and shitting or eating and puking or
eating and peeing, more likely.
Oh.
It's covered by a bunch of different places, so I don't know.
It says a possible lawsuit. The family is threatening to sue.
That motherfucker looks like he could put away 60 gallons.
My son was terribly sick, but he was also very smart. If there had been a notice on the package that ice cream could cause death, he would have never eaten so much. All of this could have been prevented if the company had taken its responsibilities. They are clearly to blame in this case. Clearly. And we definitely intend to sue them for what they have done to my son. Right. Fuck off, lady. Like, I hope that they sue you for being a fucking idiot. Like, I just think, like, all those, like, warning labels we have to... Like, really? It's on the fucking ice cream company to tell you not to eat 60 gallons?
Dude, that's so much fucking ice cream, man.
The first comment is Bob, who says, I wish I could be on the jury.
Oh, I don't know if it's real or not. I feel like it's one of those things that's ridiculous enough to maybe be real.
Yeah, that dude definitely looks like he could pack away 60 gallons.
I wonder how long it took him.
I don't know, but apparently he suffers from binge eating disorder.
I'd say.
Which is where you just eat and you can't help yourself and you just keep eating and eating and eating.
I fucking did that at Red Lobster last night, man. Oh my god, did I eat so much fucking food.
Really?
Yeah.
What do you get at Red Lobster?
What's funny is, like, I knew I was going to be eating at Red Lobster like 24 hours in advance. So I didn't eat anything for 24 hours in preparation for this. So I ended up, I got the ultimate feast, which is like,
that's two, like all the things.
It's like all of the things. Yes.
Right.
And I ate a lobster pizza appetizer, which I ate probably 3/4 of, that I shared with some other people, and I ended up eating most of it. I ate eight cheddar biscuits.
You went by yourself.
No, I went with other people. No, I wouldn't go by myself. Dude, I'm a cheap ass, man. The only reason I went is because it was somebody else paying for it. I ended up eating like 8 cheddar biscuits, like 3/4 of that lobster pizza, two things of crabs, 2 things of lobster tail, shrimp, rice,
all
salad.
From that YouTube money, huh?
What?
All from that YouTube money.
Oh, I didn't even pay for it, dude.
Oh, nice. Is it a work thing?
No, it's just a family friends thing.
Oh, okay.
That I didn't have to pay for, so fuck yeah.
We actually went last night out to I kill it in the sales department, and my boss or the owner of the company was like, take your wife out and go wherever you want for dinner and put it on me. So
wow, that's nice.
Yeah, he's a cool dude. So we went out to Firebirds, which is like a steakhouse in Richmond, and she's like, so if your boss ever says to you, take out your wife wherever you want, put it on me, don't let your wife go to a super nice steakhouse and order a fucking cheeseburger, which is what she did. I ordered like New York strip, like 20-ounce fucking steak with sauteed mushrooms and like fucking like au gratin potatoes, and it was delicious. And she orders a fucking cheeseburger for like $8. I'm like, okay, I guess you can have whatever you want, but that's
whatever.
That saddens me. You know what's funny is she's from Hawaii, and she had never had like really seafood like in her life, which is weird.
How the fuck did she manage that?
I don't know. So like we were dating.
That's actually ridiculous.
Well, she had like shrimp. She had fish, but not like she'd never had shrimp, other than like fried like fast food shrimp. She never had like real shrimp, and she'd never had crab or lobster, which is also ridiculous. But keep in mind, I mean, she's young, so I mean, it's feasible, right? So we went on our first date probably 4-ish years ago, 5 years ago, and we went to this place called Captain Groovy's in Virginia Beach, and when we were there, I ordered, do you like cocktail shrimp, like the cold ones with cocktail sauce?
Yeah.
I think those are fucking amazing. So I ordered cocktail shrimp, and they bring them out, right? And like, you know how they come out, they're cold, they're on ice, Mm-hmm. There's Cocktail, and then they have like the shell and the tail on them, right?
Yep.
And the legs. So I like turn my head. Legs? Like, yeah, they have the legs too. Yeah, they have everything.
Oh, wow. Normally they don't have the legs.
Sometimes they do. Sometimes they don't. So steam shrimp generally have the legs.
Were they veined, deveined and all that shit?
I don't know if they were deveined or not. I think because they had the shell on, they weren't. They didn't have a head on them, obviously. But, yeah. I mean, normal cocktail shrimp. So, are you Googling, are all cocktail shrimp deveined? Anyway.
No, I'm just looking up cocktail shrimp with legs. I've never seen them with the fucking...
Cocktail shrimp legs. That wasn't a good thing to Google.
I don't see what you're talking about. You mean just they have the little shell in the back? Is that what you mean by legs?
No, the fucking little legs, right? Like the fucking little dangly shrimp legs, dude.
I have never seen cocktail shrimp with the fucking legs still on them.
Hang on, dude. Hang on.
I think you're crazy.
Dude, I'm going to Google...
I looked up cocktail shrimp with legs. Nothing.
I'm telling you, bro, here's a picture of steamed shrimp, right? Here's a picture of steamed shrimp.
All of the pictures of shrimp I see have no legs.
There's a picture of shrimp. Go to that picture. Those have the legs on them.
Oh, yeah, they do. That's uncommon.
I've never seen that uncommon. You probably don't have a lot of shrimp. It's not that uncommon. Anyway... Back to my story. That's what they look like. Anyway, that picture was what they look like. But they were cold. They were on ice, right? So they bring them out, and I fucking, you know, eat one or whatever. And I'm looking out into the water because this is, like, on the beach. It's a really nice restaurant or whatever. And I hear crunch. And I, turn back around, and I'm
cheating at all.
She did not just do that. And she had just bit the thing in half, like, shell, legs, like, whole nine yards, and was, like, munching down on it, and I'm like, did you really just fucking bite that? I was like, is that good? And she's like, it's okay. And I'm like, no, look, let me show you how to fucking eat this. I was like, you could just spit that out somewhere. What's uncommon for shrimp, by the way, is this, where they have the fucking head and legs on them. I've never seen that, unless it's like some crazy Chinese buffet or something.
But yeah. Do you actually peel the shrimp shell out of the bottom part?
Usually for the cocktail shrimp, normally they don't. A lot of places will be deveined and the actual shell won't be on. It'll just be the tail.
Yeah, just the tail shell or whatever.
Yeah, you just pinch the tail off.
Yeah,
but
yeah. Most people don't know. I feel like only the fat kids know about the pinch method. Where you pinch the tail and, shoot the fucking thing down your throat.
Right. Pinch it. Well, the other one is...
I've seen people try to peel them. It's you fucking amateur. Squeeze that shit and shoot it down your throat.
Yeah. Well, so the actual shell on the body, too, you peel off sometimes. But usually you just pinch the tail off and then it peels off from the underside. Like, you peel one side and peel the other side. Anyway. Yeah, dude. She just ate it. Just like that. And
I've done that before on accident, where you bite too far or whatever.
Right. Yeah, I don't know. Oh, you talked about Red Lobster, but now crab legs and shrimp and all that shit is her favorite thing, dude. We go to crab legs all the time.
Dude, legs are a motherfucker, dude. You got to work hard for that shit.
Yeah, and don't ever take a chick, because then she'll be like, I can't get it. Can you get it for me? And then you'll have to fucking peel all her fucking shit.
Dude, who the fuck do you think I am taking a chick to Red Lobster?
Do you
think I'm some sort of millionaire?
You don't take a chick you're dating to Red Lobster unless you're I don't know, no.
You'd spend at least $100, right?
$100. It's at least $100, exactly.
Dude, that Red Lobster bill was $350.
You know what it is for my company? So a lot of times we have work dinners at our company and we have 10 or 12 sales guys.
Uh-huh.
Plus management, plus the owner or whatever.
I'm sure that's $2,000.
There's 15 people, and we get an appetizer for every two or three people. Everybody has alcohol, pretty much whatever you want, and then dinner. Yeah, I'm sure he drops a couple grand every time we go out.
Yeah.
Which, I mean, is cool. I mean, that's, you know, I mean, it's a work meeting, you know. I mean, like, what are you supposed to buy your own dinner at a work meeting? But it's really cool of them. I mean, it's a good gig, but it's like a perk. But, yeah, dude, that's, dinners get expensive, dude. Like I said, that's why my roommate, when I was living in Norfolk, I had a roommate who was like a womanizer. And it was actually the only time in my life I've ever had experience with an escort service was when my roommate was bored on a Friday night and he ordered an escort. It was ridiculous. Have you ever, like, you know those exist, right?
Yeah, I know they exist. I mean, you can even see them in, like, the back of the phone books and shit, depending on what state
you're in. When's the last time you fucking looked in a phone book?
Me and my brother used to do it at hotels just to, like, fuck around. Like, when we were on vacation, we'd look at the phone book and just, like, fuck with people.
The thing with escorts that boggles my mind is, like, that's not a common thing. Like, if you're a chick and you're, like, in your early 20s, like, how hard up do you have to be to become, like, go work at a fucking escort place? Like,
I think the new thing is the sugar daddies and sugar baby thing. That's, like, the new common thing that's going on.
Yeah, but where do you sign up? Like, how do you list yourself? Like,
there's websites for it where these chicks will just post pictures of themselves and be like, hey, I'm in college and I need fucking money because college is expensive. And they fucking, you know, some 40-plus-year-old dude is like, I got money and you're hot. Let's fucking go. And that's what they do.
Do they have to fuck them or do they just, like, hang out?
It's very implied.
Oh, okay. Well, anyway, so he found this thing on, I don't know where he, I think it might have been Craigslist where he found it, but it was really weird. Like, number one, like, I was 100% that the chick in the picture that actually showed up at our house wasn't going to be the same chick. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
It was going to be some, like, 20-year-old blonde, like, fucking bombshell in the picture and a fucking, like, 35-year-old fat, black, fucking toothless fucking ham beast was going to knock on our door. But that actually wasn't the case. It was the same chick.
Wow.
Didn't look as good, right? Like, obviously was doctored up for the fucking picture. But it was the same person. So, I guess that's that. But,
did everything go according to plan?
It was weird because, like, we didn't really know, like, he's the one that did it, right? Like, I just was like, I just wanted, was more like, hey, this thing is about to happen, which will probably never happen again in my life.
You want to be there for it.
I probably should just stick around. Yeah. See how this plays out. So I'm like, fuck yeah. Yeah, I was like coaxing him on to do it or whatever. So, like, he orders this chick, and, like, we don't know what to expect either. You know what I mean? So,
yeah. What do you do? Just, like, call him on the phone and say, I'm down?
Yeah. You call him on the phone, and it's like a service that answers. And they're like, hello?
It's like a third party involved.
Yeah. No, you don't call the chick directly.
Oh.
You call, like, her fucking handler or whatever. her, like, mom, whatever they call him. Right. So we call, and, like, the other thing is, like, I don't know, like, they want to prove you're, like, not a cop. So, like, you have to, like, I forget, I'm trying to remember the specifics, but I think he called, and I think they had to call him back after they, like, checked his phone number or some shit. I don't know. It was weird. They, like, call back. Anyway, he sets this up. So she comes out, knocks on the door, comes in, and, like, we're both like, okay, like, she's here. Like, I don't really know, like, what's going to happen next. Like, but apparently what they do is, like, I guess they, like, give you massages or, like, do a strip show or whatever. So what's really awkward is, like, I went and got a beer, and I was just sitting on the couch. And, like, he was sitting on, like, the recliner chair thing with a beer. And we're just, like, staring at this chick, like, I'm not sure what goes on next or whatever. But she does, like, this really awkward, like, strip show thing in our living room. And then, like, starts, like, grinding on him as if it was a strip club. And then, I don't know, like, they went upstairs to his room, and I assume that he banged her or something. But it was just weird, dude. It was just strange, because, like, she did, like, imagine being a chick in the middle of some dude's living room where they're staring at you like a fucking hungry lion staring at a wildebeest. Like, and like, they're just, like, go.
Was the chick actually hot, like, when she got there?
Yeah, she wasn't bad. I mean, she wasn't, like, a fucking, like, nine. She was like a
How much does that even fucking cost? Like, what does that even run? I'm not even familiar with the fucking numbers.
I'm pretty sure he paid like $200 or $300. He paid a lot of money. But
see, that's like one of those things, like, yeah, it can vary so much.
I don't know. I don't know if they actually banged. I can't remember, honestly. I know they did something that was sexual, but I can't remember if he actually banged her or she just, like, blew him. But it's just weird, dude. Like, that totally happened, like, right out of, like, fucking Craigslist. You know what I mean? And
yeah, I couldn't. I don't think I could do that. Like, not that way, anyway.
Just blow a dude for $200?
Are you going to go back to that conversation of, like, how low would you go?
No,
I just, like, I don't think I could, like, order a chick through Craigslist.
I mean, when you have, like, it's different. Well,
like, there's definitely some high-end prostitutes that I would absolutely, like, if I had the disposable income, if I felt comfortable spending the money, then I would, but, because there's some prostitutes that don't even look like fucking prostitutes.
Hang on, wait a minute. So, like, what is the most you would pay for sex? Like, assume that the chick... Who's, like, one of the hottest chicks that you can think of right now?
I don't know. I don't know. I probably wouldn't pay the money right now because I don't have it. Like, I have it, but I don't fucking... I wouldn't want to spend it. Like, I just go without because it's not that important to me.
Right, but, like, no consequences aside, whatever, you could bang whatever chick you want, whatever actress you think is the hottest. Would you pay $100 for that?
Yeah, anybody. Yeah, of course.
That'd be $500.
For anybody?
Anybody. No consequences. Do whatever you want for a couple hours. $500?
Yeah, probably $500. That'd probably be where I maxed out for now. I mean, because I don't know. I feel like you'd be an asshole if you didn't do it. Because this is like some mythical situation where it's anybody. Like, this is like a magical question that's not realistic.
So, well, I mean, the thing is, like, because my thing, like, you know, I did the online dating back in the day, right? Like, everyone, I assume everybody does. And, like...
I think that's what most people do now.
I don't know how loud I can be. But anyway, like, I would, you know, there were some chicks that I obviously wasn't going to go on a second date with, that I obviously wasn't that into, but yet I wanted to just, like, see it to the end, if you know what I mean. So, like, I, you know... Right. You eventually get it. And as soon as you do... Right, as soon as you're done, as soon as you fucking, you know, fucking blow your nut and you're finished, like, the only thing you want in the entire world is them to be out of your house and, like, so you can go play video games or go do something, get back on with your life. Like, you don't have any more interest in them. Like, that happened to me. Like, it sounds terrible, but, like right after I scored with some chicks and I was done, immediately after being done, like, I wanted to forget all about it and just go on with, like, the rest of the things that I actually enjoyed. So, like, the reason I say that is that I think there's a limit on the number of dollars that you spend where, like, even if it was, like, Jennifer Lawrence or Lauren German, who I think is super hot, or Jessica Biel, or name anybody, like, after a while, like, yeah, it would be amazing during it, right? And, like, before, and the memory would be cool, but, like, as soon as you blow your nut, you're gonna be really sad when you go to your bank account and realize.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. That's where I was thinking too. I was just like,
there's $1,000 that's just gone.
That's why I wouldn't go. That's why I wouldn't go that high.
Right.
But then again, like, if I'm in, like, some situation where, like, I'm, like, 60 years old and I've got, like, more money than God, then fuck it.
Right.
But I'm not there yet, so, like, I don't know.
I think for me right now, if I had to put a number on it, I would say $500 is probably the most I would spend.
Yeah, and it's not that I couldn't spend more than that. It's just that I wouldn't. I'm not interested in spending more than that.
Right. Interesting.
I like how philosophical we've gotten on this fucking particular topic.
Exactly.
All right, I think that number could definitely. I think that number would definitely go up if I had an insane amount of money. I was comfortable. So if I was like a billionaire, like, I wouldn't give a fuck.
Well, right. I mean, but if you're a billionaire, like, you don't need to ask the chicks. Right? Like, yeah, you don't even need to ask that question.
Yeah.
Chicks all over your dick anyway, no matter if you're married.
That's the one good thing about being a dude, is that as a dude, you can improve your fucking, your 1 through 10 rating way easier than a chick can. Like, some chicks are just born a fucking 4 or a 5, and there's nothing you can do about it. Like, I feel like a lot of dudes, like, you can just hit the gym, work out, and, like, bump your score up at least a few points, or you can just be incredibly wealthy and you're a fucking 10.
Have you seen the poster chick for Hot Body Ugly Face?
No.
This chick is like the famous internet like butterface fucking queen. Like whenever you see an article about Hot Body Ugly Face, that chick always comes up.
Oh no.
Isn't that tragic?
I don't think her face is that bad though.
Serious? I mean,
it's not that bad.
She looks like a cannon.
But it like in comparison to the fucking body though.
Right, exactly.
That is fucking depressing.
It's tragic, isn't it? Like, look at her fucking cans.
Yeah, that's pretty...
Like, here you go. 15 hot bodies.
Dude, I almost feel like that's a fake picture, dude.
It's not a... Like, look at the link I just linked. Hot body, ugly face. She's number one. And then there are some other ones on here. I mean, like... Yeah. I don't know. The number 7 is a pretty bad one, too.
I feel like the number 1 is definitely better than all of these other ones, though.
Really? Dude, that's, like, she's definitely, like, a solid average. Like, look at number 7, dude. Number 7, like...
Yeah, like, her face her is fucking fucked.
Dude, her right
like,
eye...
So, see, I don't think number 1's face is, like, completely, completely fucked. But some of these chicks, their faces are fucked. Like
number
like,
7, her
like,
right
number
eye
1 is, like, an average, like, whatever face. It's just, like, it looks bad because her body looks so good. But these other faces are just fucked. Like, number 3? What the fuck?
Lady Gaga.
Number 4? What the fuck? Number 7? What the fuck?
Dude, number 8? Seven, her right eye fucking noped out of the face party. Like, her face is, the rest of her face is, like, dead the fuck on. And her right eye just fucking took a right turn. Yeah, look at number 8, dude. That's just a bad picture. Well, and she has bad teeth. But,
I don't even know why number 8's on this fucking list. What's so great about that?
Yeah, exactly. I think it's just because she's ugly. But, yeah.
Yeah, some of these chicks shouldn't even be on the best body list at all. What?
Yeah, well, I mean, EEMGN.com.
This number 1 chick, I gotta be honest, that is fucking crazy. That's... Yeah.
She's like the poster chick for Hot Body Ugly Hot Body Ugly Face. She's like the chick that always comes up.
Yeah.
I don't think that's fake. I think it's real.
She's not that bad, though. But it is, like, the contrast is fucking huge there.
Exactly. Oh, man. Oh, man. Anyway.
All right. Well, we've been going for, what, 2 hours and 45 minutes? I don't have anything that's, like, any crazy topics. Unless you do.
No,
I'm down if you have another topic, but...
No. We can talk about it at different points. Well, I think the week is going to bring some more stories. 3 hours is pretty solid.
Yeah. 3 hours. Well, if you have anything you want to bring up, I'm not against going on a little longer, but if you don't, then we can just edit here.
Yep. Just follow me on Twitter.
Yeah. All right, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed Hive Mind number 18, right? 18?
Yeah.
Yeah, 18. We're on YouTube, SoundCloud, iTunes. Check us out all those places. Follow us on Twitter. It's on the screen at Zyback TV at Dopamine X, right? Yeah. So yeah, check us out wherever you want to watch us, and we'll see you again next week. Bye.
Later.